就今天上午就经常会讲到祈祷这个问题，然后正好我对祈祷是有一个很大的一个困惑，所以想借此机会问一下，请教一下。
So you, this morning you talked a lot about prayer and praying, and I have a lot of questions around praying.
就是我很长时间就没有去祈祷，甚至说是回避祈祷。因为我觉得就是耶稣教给我们这个法门是让我们离开这个表象的这个虚幻的世界，但是我却这么想得到这个世界里面的某一个事情或者一个东西。
So, for a long period of time, I've been avoiding prayer because I think Jesus bring a course of miracles to this world, and the purpose is to get us away from this world.But there is such a draw to want different things in this world.
所以我就会宽恕自己这个愿望，我就不要让自己有太强烈的这种愿望去得到。
So I have been just working on forgiving my desire of anything in this world.
所以我就回避祈祷很长一段时间。但就有一天突然就心里有一个声音很大的声音在告诉我，就说。你要大声地把你的想法要表达出来，要喊出来，要说出来。
So because of that, over a long period of time, I've been avoiding praying for anything in this world. But at one point, I realized there was an inner voice that was telling me I should voice whatever I want and whatever I desire, and I should let it come out.
然后我就照着这个声音去做了。然后我觉得非常的喜悦，我觉得把自己的潜意识里面的想法就真的表达出来了，我就觉得非常的开心。
And I followed the guidance, I followed the voice. I experienced a lot of joy in allowing the voice to come out, my inner voice to come out.
但是就即便有这样一个体验以后呢，我自己在祈祷的时候，我还是会有这样一个比较混乱的一个状态，就是一个矛盾的心理。
But even though with this kind of experience, I still have a lot of confusion and doubt thoughts in my mind around prayer.
所以就想请问大卫老师，这样就是如何去祈祷，如何去就是理解这样的一个矛盾？这是第一个问题。
So the first question is how to understand this internal conflict around that, like wanting to avoid the desire, but at the same time I need to voice the desire.The same time, it seems to be a conflict.
然后还有一个问题呢，就是大卫老师就讲，有一个癌症患者在参加了六个星期的那个以后，他就完全康复了。因为我的身体也不是特别好，所以就很想了解这是如何做到的。
The second question is around physical healing, because you mentioned there was a case where someone came to the devotional with cancer and left cancer free.Because I have a lot of physical concerns, so I want to know how was that achieved.
Okay. Well, I think you are on the right direction with prayer when you ask to be in touch with voicing your inner desires.
我觉得你实际上是在这个祈祷是踏上正轨了。当如果你认就是你受到的这个灵感是要把自己内心的想法给它说出来，是很正确的。
In more of the Western tradition, there is so much talk about and written about prayer.
因为在西方的这个宗教里面，我们实际上是经常谈到或者会提到这个祈祷。
And in the Eastern traditions, there's more talk of meditation and stillness.
然后在中国或者是东方这边传统的灵性的，通常是会提到冥想呀，或者是宁静啊。
And I think as you go deeper with prayer, you do move away from words and from petitions or asking for things.
那实际上，你如果是在越来越深的进入到这个祈祷状态的时候，实际上你会很越来越远的离开这种去要什么东西。或者是去祈求什么东西的这样的一个状态。
When Helen had received A Course in Miracles, she was still working with her friend Ken Wapnick about punctuation and things related to the course.
然后当时海伦接受到奇迹课程这本书的时候，然后把它写下来以后，她还跟那个她的朋友那个肯尼斯一起去研究去怎么加标点符号啊这些具体的细节工作。
And both Helen and Ken had more questions about prayer. They wanted more clarity about prayer.
在当时他们在整理资料的过程中，海伦还有这个肯尼斯，他们两个人都同时对这个祈祷有很多的问题。
So Jesus gave a little pamphlet called the Song of Prayer.
所以那个基督耶稣他就又继续写了，就是要求海伦写了另外一部这个附注，叫做颂祷。
Describing prayer as a ladder.
然后他把这个祈祷就形容成是一个梯子，有不同的台阶。
So the lower rungs of the ladder is where you get into asking for things, petitioning spirit for things.
所以在最初的比较低层的这个祈祷的阶段的话，那通常的这个形式就是向基督耶稣祈求具体得到具体的东西。
And this could even include asking for specific things.
这个就是包括企图得到一些非常具体的情况啊或者事情。
And the reason why there is a lower part of the ladder is because when the mind believes in lack.
这个就是这一步之所以是在那儿，而且是非常重要的一步，就是因为当我们的心灵还是相信匮乏的时候。
It has made up a self-concept that needs things.
他就是把自己认同一个非常匮乏的一个自我概念，然后觉得自己需要一些其他的东西。
And so that's why, at that level, it's appropriate to pray and even ask for things.
所以在那个时候，当我们非常认同一个这样的一个自我概念的时候，实际上就是说不可避免的，我们的祈祷就会要求想要一些东西，这个也是很自然的。
But Spirit knows the prayer of the heart before there is even a word.
但是实际上，圣灵是知道我们的心灵的愿望是什么的，哪怕我们说不用语言表达出来，他是知道的。
So sometimes people receive what they pray for, but this is always when it is helpful.
所以我们其实是总是得到我们想要真正想要的东西的，但是我们得到的东西总是对我们最有帮助的。
And then as you move higher up the ladder of prayer, you may ask for different qualities like patience or strength.
但是当你持续的祈祷，然后当你达到了一个比较高的这种祈祷程度的话，你可能会发现你所祈祷的是一些具体的特性，比如说你希望有耐心，你希望有一些这种特性。
So the prayer becomes more aimed at states of mind.
然后这个时候，这个祈祷的东西就会变成是更心灵的一种状态。
Now, the reason that you advance higher in prayer is you start to see what's going on when you ask for specific things.
你之所以能够从这个比较低层次这个祈祷的这个等级往上走，是因为你当你得到了一些具体的事情的时候，你可以能。感受到它能给你带来什么。
So when you ask for something specific, you're really asking for the past to be repeated in some way that you believe is beneficial.
因为每当你祈祷想要具体的事情发生的时候，实际上你祈祷的是希望过去的经历能够在现在重复体验。
But the more that you see that you don't want to ask for the past to be repeated,You've let go of asking and petitioning for things.
当你逐渐地意识到你实际上不再需要过去去一步一次次地重复自己的时候，那么你就开始放弃这个念头，想要具体的东西。
Because the part is difficult is thinking that you already know what is beneficial for you while you're still asleep and dreaming.
因为这个，当你的心灵还处在沉睡状态的时候，如果你觉得你自己知道什么是对你最好的，什么能够带给你心灵平安，实际上是这个不是一个正确的感觉。
And so, as we go up the ladder, we can see that prayer is just another word for desire.
所以，当我们继续往这个 祈祷的这个阶梯上往上走的时候，到上面，我其实能够，我们能够感觉到。
Another word for desire, like a synonym.
所以祈祷实际上就是跟你的愿望是同一个词，同义词。
And so as you go up the ladder, you desire peace of mind or happiness, joy.
所以当你继续往上走的话，你会意识到实际上你的心里的愿望是你希望要有心灵的平安，你希望有喜悦的心情。
And the highest form of prayer is when you ask God, show me your will for me, reveal your will for me. That's the highest prayer that you can ask.
然后最大的当达到祈祷最高的那个程度的时候，实际上那个祷告词就是，上主，你的圣愿是什么？
But you can only really ask that prayer when you're ready to ask that prayer, when you actually want to be shown God's will.
但是你在达到那个程度的时候，你真的是要真心的已经准备好要接受，这个才是你真正想要的，你才可能去做出这样的祈祷。
So you were saying that there are times when you try to avoid desiring anything of this world.
你刚才提到曾经有一段阶段，你是一直在回避去祈祷，要求要这个世界上的任何的东西。
So we have to look at this very carefully. What does this mean?
所以我们需要仔细的看一下这个是一个什么情况。
In the Bible, there was a man who sang songs called the Psalms, and his name was David.
然后在圣经中，我不知道
Psalms。
Psalms.
Songs.
Songs.
He sang songs. Like I sing.
圣歌吧，
圣歌在圣经里面是 David sang the songs.
David sang and wrote a lot of songs.
就在圣经里面也有一个叫大卫的，他是当时写了很多的颂歌。
His name was, he was King David.
他是大卫王。
And he had wrote a famous one called the 23rd Psalm.
他写了一个非常非常著名的是叫第二十三个颂诗。
If there's anyone who's Christian, they're probably familiar with it.
如果你们是基督徒的话，你应该对那个很了解。
But the song starts off, "The Lord is my shepherd; I shall not want."
然后他的那个圣诗的开始第一句就是。上主是我的牧羊人，我什么都不要。
So he was singing to God, saying, "I shall not have any desires."
然后他实际上那个就是在对上主在唱，我不应该要求任何的东西。
But the point of prayer in the mind is also the point of power.
所以在我们的心灵中，当我们开始祈祷的时候，那个也是我们力量所在。
So, in one sense, when you say, I shall not desire, it's a saying, I don't want to be aware of the power.
所以当每次当你跟自己说我不希望对任何东西有愿望的时候，实际上你也说我不希望看到自己的心灵的强大的能力。
And this avoidance comes from the belief in misuse of power.
这个原因是因为我们想要回避，我们不想去滥用我们心灵的这个强大的力量功能。
So when you pray truly, you are joining with the Spirit in the power.
但是当你真正的开始祈祷的时候，你会跟圣灵一起，你会把圣灵带到这个你的心强大的心灵当中来。
But also joining in forgetting the things that you think you need.
而且同时你会跟圣灵一起忘记你认为你需要的东西。
And this fits with our talk this morning in trusting the Holy Spirit to provide everything.
这个跟我们今天早上讲的就是一定要相信圣灵，把自己的一切都交托给他，认为他能够提供给我们任何的事情是非常相关的。
Jesus says, the secret to true prayer is to forget the things you think you need.
因为基督曾经说过，真正的祈祷的秘密就是你要忘记你认为 你所想要的东西是什么。
So this is also a song of gratitude.
所以这个实际上也是一个就是感恩的一个颂诗。
It's like singing to God, saying thank you for providing everything that I need.
所以实际上你的祈祷可以就是在感恩上主，跟他说谢谢你已经提供给我我所需要的一切。
Without really focusing on the need.
而不是具体的去把注意力集中在我到底需要什么具体的东西。
So in one way, this is what you've been praying for. You've been wanting that.
所以我能感觉到这也是你内心的愿望。
But the Holy Spirit also knows you cannot skip over any beliefs.
但是基督是知道我们不能跳过去我们现在的阶段。
So earlier today we talked about desiring a soulmate.
所以今天早上起来我们也谈到我们比如说有一些愿望是想要找一个灵魂伴侣。
And again, this can be asking the Spirit for what would be helpful in my awakening.
所以这个实际上也是同时是一个就是可以跟圣灵去说到底对我的心灵开悟有什么是有帮助的。
And in this way, the Spirit transforms special relationships into holy relationships.
然后在这个愿望之下，圣灵就会把你的特殊关系转变成神圣关系。
By giving them a new purpose.
然后他会给你的关系赋予新的目的。
But not trying to jump over what you still believe in.
但在这样的话，我们也用不着去跳过我们现有的这个阶段，然后故意的跳过去。
So, the ego is a filter in the mind.
所以小我在我们的心灵中就像一个过滤镜。
And the Holy Spirit must come through the filter to reach the mind with where it believes it is.
然后圣灵其实它是需要透过就是小我的这个过滤镜来达到我们的心灵。
So, oftentimes in monasteries and in convents.
所以在传统的这个修道院里面。
The monks are asked to take vows.
要加入修道院的和尚们都要去发誓。
Like poverty, chastity, obedience.
他们通常要宣誓，要一辈子要保持贫穷啊、贞洁啊这些。
And if their mind is ready for the vow, then it can be helpful.
那如果当时心灵跟这个他所发的誓言实际上在同一个状态的话。那这个誓言实际上是对心灵有帮助的。
But if the mind is not ready for the vow, then it gets into repression and denial.
但是如果当时的心灵状态其实还没有达到他这个誓言所发的这个状态，还没有准备好，那么他发这个誓言，然后继续这样做，实际上就等于是一个逃避和一个压抑。
Because part of the mind wants to get rid of the desire.
因为心灵的一部分是想把这些欲望和愿望都给他。排斥出去。
And the other part of the mind has the desire.
然后，但是心灵的另一部分实际上是有这些欲望的。
So there is a resistance and a conflict going on in the mind.
所以他在心灵中就会有这些矛盾和这些抗拒性存在。
And this is why the prayer has to be practical.
所以就是为什么就是我们的祈祷一定要是非常的实际。
The Holy Spirit knows how to unwind the mind from the guilt.
然后圣灵实际上是知道怎么来逐步的把我们的心灵解开这个枷锁。
But it doesn't come from desiring certain outcomes or pushing away certain outcomes.
但是我们要想达到这点的话，既不能去故意逃避某些的结局，也不是故意的去追求某些结局。
So it reminds me of a line from The Matrix.
然后这个就跟我们那个《骇客帝国》那个电影里面有一句话是这样描述的。
Has anyone seen the movie The Matrix?
你们都看过《骇客帝国》的电影吗
？Yeah, and the Oracle is talking to Neo.
然后当时里面那个 Oracle 那个算命的那个女的就跟那个 Neo 说。
And she's saying no one can perceive the answer from a level that they're not ready to receive.
他说你当你的心灵还没有准备好接受这个答案的时候，你是看不到这个答案的存在的。
And it's very similar to when the Morpheus takes Neo to see the Oracle in the first movie.
然后在因为在那个黑客帝国第一部的时候，那个 Morpheus 他带着 Neo 去看这个算命的时候。
And he's going to her to find out if he is the one.
他去的目的是想从他嘴里面得知自己到底是不是 the one， 就是是不是那个救世主。
And first she says, "Let me see your hand."
然后他一开始说让我看看你的手指，看你的掌纹。
And she gives him more time.
然后他实际上给你有更多的时间去考虑。
Then the oracle says, "Open your mouth."
然后他说你张开你的嘴让我看你的牙。
She looks down at his teeth and his throat. She said, "Ah."
然后他看了看他的牙齿和喉咙，说啊啊。
She's giving him more time.
然后他其实是在给你有更多的时间。
And then she looks into his eyes and she says, "But you already know what I'm going to say."
但他最后看着Neo的眼睛，说实际上你也知道我要跟你说什么，对不对？
Because she has already told him, no one can tell you that you are the one.
因为他已经跟他说了，实际上你从外界是不，你不可能有外界的人告诉你你是这个救世主。
You have to discover it for yourself.
你这个发现一定要发自内心。
And yet he's there looking at her, waiting for her to give him the answer.
但是当时的时候，他就是在等着他。这个算命的这个预言家给他一个答案。
So he's not ready to have the experience that he is the one.
所以他当时实际上还没有准备好，就是说从自而内的发现自己就是救世主。
And she reflects that back to him, and she tells him, "You're not the one."
所以他当时也没有选择，只能反馈给他自己的心里的想法，所以他就说你不是那个救世主。
It's actually he that says the words, "I'm not the one."
实际上，这个是你有自己心里的想法，我不是那个救世主。
And she reflects, "Sorry."
然后他只不过是在反馈回来他的想法。
And it's the same with prayer.
这个跟那个祈祷的作用是一样的。
If we cannot pray for things that we're not ready to receive.
我们不可能去祈祷去得到一些我们还没有准备好接受的东西。
And so, in that sense, that is why you felt good getting in touch with your inner voice.
这也就是为什么你实际上能够感觉到喜悦。当你允许你内心的愿望被表达出来的时候，能感觉到喜悦。
You are just getting in touch with your inner guidance.
因为那个能够允许你跟内心的这个指引相连接。
Of what things or what steps would be helpful next for you?
然后你能感受到这个指引会告诉你。下一步要怎么走，什么东西会对你有帮助。
And that will activate joy inside of you.
它会使你，会激发出你内心的喜悦。
Because it is the spirit that is answering you.
因为是圣灵，其实是在回答你。
So you desire forgiveness and awakening.
所以如果你的愿望是宽恕和觉醒的话，
And then the spirit will filter through your belief system.
然后圣灵会通过你层层的信念系统下来达到你的内心。
And then we'll give you what you need next.
然后会提供给你下一步需要什么东西。
And we'll keep helping you loosen from all beliefs and needs.
然后会带领你逐渐的去摆脱这些层层的信念系统对你的束缚。
So it is really very, very loving.
所以这个是一个非常有爱的一个过程。
And what was the second question?
第二个问题是什么？
有一个癌症患者。
Physical healing.
Physical healing. Well, all healing is mental healing.
就是说，所有的疗愈都是在心灵层面的疗愈。
And what seems to be the removal of symptoms,
哪怕是有些是身体上的症状消失了，
is a temporary reflection of mind.
它只不过是一个短暂性的一个反射出心灵当时的一个状态。
Really, the body is just a symbol.
实际上就是我们的身体只不过是一个符号。
And to the Holy Spirit, it's a neutral symbol.
对于圣灵来讲，它是非常非常中性的一个符号。
But the ego endows the body with with life and with health.
然后是小我实际上是把这个身体赋予了生命，然后赋予了健康。
And it also projects sickness from the mind to the body.
同时也投射了就是种种的心灵上面的疾病，然后把它投射在身体上。
And so this is a trick.
所以这个就是一个诡计。
And when the symptoms are removed, it's really, the question is really, is the mind clear and healed?
所以当你们看到就是在身体上面的这个层面的病症消失了被治愈的时候，真正的问题是要问，那心灵上有没有受到疗愈？
The real prayer is Holy Spirit, heal my mind.
所以我们的祈祷在这个时候总是应该是圣灵，请你治愈我的心灵。
And this means heal my perception of the body.
然后这个同时也是在说，请你治愈我对这个身体的看法。
So it's never helpful to ask the Holy Spirit to heal the body.
所以这个，如果你是想要圣灵去治愈你身体的这些症状的话，是一个其实是没有任何帮助的。
Because the body is never the problem.
因为身体永远不是问题的本在。
It's just the attack thoughts in the mind.
那都是心灵上面的攻击性念头才是问题所在。
That get projected onto the body.
然后这些攻击性念头被投射到身体上。
So if you release the grievance in the mind,
所以如果你把心灵里面这些怨尤全都消除了的话，
the body will just serve as a helpful symbol or an instrument.
这个身体就会变成一个非常有用的一个工具或者一个符号。
But you don't need to put any focus on the body.
但你不需要把任何的精力和注意力放在这个身体上。
Because again, it's just a symbol.
因为再一次的讲，它就是一个符号。
And when this friend Joanne came to our six-week devotional,
然后我们这个朋友 Joanne 她来到我们这个六星期的这个工作坊的时候，
we focused entirely on healing in the mind.
我们当时的注意力完全就是怎么疗愈心灵。
And what she saw at the end was just a reflection of her state of mind.
然后他最后的这个结果也只不过是对他心灵疗愈的一个反射。
I don't think she even came to the devotional purposefully to heal the cancer.
就他当时来我们来这个共修的时候，并不是目的，并不是来治愈这个癌症来的。
She just came to get in contact with the spirit.
他来的目的只不过是想跟内心的圣灵有一个链接。
And that happened.
然后这个治愈就发生了。
嘉宾老师你好，我是第一次来参加这个课程的。
Hello David, this is my first workshop with you.
然后其实我记不清我是从哪一年开始练习奇迹课程的，但是我已经练习完两遍了。
I don't recall the first time I started the course, but I finished.I've done the work lesson for two rounds.
然后呢，最开始学习奇迹课程的时候，就是有一位，就是一直在跟一位道友一起学习，在他的帮助下在学习奇迹课程。
I studied the course under the help of a course friend.
然后没有更多的人就是给我提供其他的帮助。
I didn't receive any help from other people.
然后当我听到就是大卫老师来北京的时候，我在想我到底要不要来参加这个课程。
And when I first heard about your trip to China, I was asking myself whether I should come.
然后在静心打坐的时候，当时是很纠结的。
So I had a lot of conflict in my mind, and I went into meditation.
然后最后，在最后的时候就。看到在静心的时候看到大卫老师非常光明的一个形象，然后向我张开双臂欢迎我来这儿学习。
And in my meditation I had a vision of you in light, open your arm welcoming me to come to this workshop.
所以我来这儿并没有什么问题想要问大卫老师。
So I didn't come with any questions to ask you.
只是想向大卫老师表示感谢和无限的爱。
So I just want to express my gratitude and endless love.
Yeah.
然后，我想，就是只是想说，我真的很喜欢宽恕，也很喜欢奇迹，很喜欢大卫老师，很喜欢爱。
So I want to say that I love forgiveness, I love A Course in Miracles, I love you, David, and I love love. And I've been thinking about what kind of question I can bring to this class. And what I can learn from this weekend. But in this moment, I felt like I learned everything. This is all I want. Thank you so much. I saw you both in Shanghai and in Hainan last time.
就是，然后上奇迹课程这几年，让我觉得非常的平静，然后就是非常非常的丰盛。
I feel very peaceful and abundant after I got into the course.
无论是关系上，还是财富上，还是事业上，就是上主给了我想要的一切，甚至更多。
I feel the spirit have given me everything and more than what I wanted in terms of relationship, in terms of money and career.
我们之间有一个特别好的关系，就是我能随时感觉到他，然后他也随时能出现来支持我。
And I have a very good relationship with the spirit. I feel his presence and I feel his support whenever I need.
但是就是在四月份的时候，发现我又有恐惧了。然后我就觉得，然后前几天我就觉得是不是该做这个练习了，因为我很久没有做了。然后手机上就出现了老师要来的上课的一个信息，大概一个星期以前。
But around April, I started to feel there's some fear bubbling up in my mind again, and I thought maybe it's time for me to do some more practice. And in that very moment, I received the message of this workshop of yours.
我想是不是就是工作太忙碌，也会让我们就是真的切断和这个圣灵或者上主的这个链接。就是好像我回忆了一下，有一段时间我真的没有跟他们链接，应该有很长一段时间了。
So I guess I want to know whether just put too much attention to work will stop my connection with the Holy Spirit, because I can honestly say that I haven't really focusing on connecting with the Holy Spirit in the last few months.
然后这个恐惧就到了极点。我坐飞机的时候，我就整个人心脏都要炸掉，我觉得这飞机如果真的掉下去了怎么办？特别的恐怖，而且那个空姐都过来安抚我，她已经看到我很紧张了。
And fear started to come out in all kinds of ways in a very intense way. For example, when I flew over here, I couldn't help but thinking, what if the plane would explode? And I was so frightened that the hair hostess had come to comfort me.
然后现在我喜欢的运动，潜水啊，过山车这些比较激烈一点的我都玩不了。
And I couldn't really engage in the hobbies I used to have. They're very like extreme sports or even roller coaster rides. I
最深的恐惧是，因为我上一次做练习的时候走得挺深入的，就这一年半就经历了很多。然后我现在在想做这个练习的时候，就是是不是这个是我想做这个练习的恐惧投射到这些事情上。
So my question is, last time when I was practicing the course or the lessons, I went really deep. But this time, maybe because I was ready to give it another go, and the ego is kicking and screaming and projecting all the fear onto the specific scenarios in the world.
因为奇迹课程对我的意义太大了，就是我觉得它太有效了。就是我上过很多的灵性课程，基本上，因为谁见了我都知道我上的课多，想让我推荐。我那个时候就忘记了所有的，就只有四个字：奇迹课程。
Because I know the power of A Course in Miracles, I've been on so many spiritual paths and spiritual courses. Everybody knows how many courses I've taken, so they always ask me which pathway is the best. But every time when I face this question, everything suddenly disappear in my mind except four words, A Course in Miracles.
他的每一个字都激励着我，我对奇迹课程每一句话没有任何的怀疑，而且只要我去读的话，我就可以像就是至死不像献出生命一样，可以去践行他的理论。所以我真的过了有三年特别平静，那种平安上读天心里的那种幸福。但是这段时间，我想是该练习了，所有的恐惧就都冒出来了。
So because I have no doubt, and so much faith and confidence with the course, every single word of the course, and when I practice, I gave my everything to the practice. So I spent about 3 years in complete peace and joy, in the past. But now I think I'm ready to give it another go. So all the fears start to come out.
对，然后我想请老师分享和指引一下。然后第二就是，就是。
This is the first question. Like, do you have any guidance around this?
然后第二个问题就是，我对灵性电影有很多的意愿。然后我真的知道这个技术和这个电影，它真的可以很轻易的支持到别人。
And the second is, my desire or my wish to support spiritual movies.Because I know that the technology and the movies and the power of the combination of the two, how that can support the awakening.
So
that's it.
Okay. Well, your first question is something that I hear many people talk about. It's quite common, the experiences.
你的第一个问题就是实际上是一个非常常见的一个问题，我经常听到很多的人问同样的问题。
There can seem to be a period where things just seem to all click and flow together in terms of aspects of the world.
就是当你练习这个一段时间以后，你会发现哪怕是在这个表象世界，很多东西开始都非常顺利，非常流动。
And this phase is very much like a honeymoon phase with two newlyweds.
然后我把这种期间就叫做是就好像是新婚的蜜月期一样。
After they get married, everything goes very, very well.
那你刚刚开始新婚的时候，一切都变得非常美好，非常顺利。
So well that they're just oblivious to the world and to problems because everything is going so smoothly.
一切都是如此的美好，所以也没有什么世间的烦恼能够打扰我们。
I remember for myself, I had a very similar period where I just thought, oh, this is fantastic. I just want this to be the rest of my life.
我记得在我自己的这个修行的过程中，也有过这样的一段时期。我当时就觉得，哎呀，这个实在是太美好了，我真希望它能够永远这样持续下去。
And Jesus said, oh, there's more.
然后当时圣灵就跟我说，我们还有很多东西需要继续。
I remember when I was reading the manual for teachers, the stages of the development of trust.
然后当时我在看那个教师手册里面是，就是培养我们对圣灵的信任的几个阶段。
And Jesus described 6 stages that you would go through as you learn to develop trust.
他当时对这个我们对圣灵培养信任。
So I did like most students, I read it, I said, which stage am I in?
This one.
Maybe both. Maybe all three. No, I didn't know, but I was reading, wondering where I fit.
So I read a lot of 奇迹学员说，当我读到那个的时候，我就一直在看到底我是在哪个阶段，是这个阶段还是这个阶段？没，可能是两个阶段都是，也可能是这个阶段，所以一直在比较。
But eventually I stepped back and I looked at the 6 stages and I said, wow, 4 of them are difficult and hard and 2 of them are nice.
但是后来我就开始退后一步，我就在很客观地看这个六个阶段，我发现六个阶段里面其中的四个阶段都是非常艰难的阶段，只有两个阶段是还不错的阶段。
So I was like, okay, thank you, Jesus, for showing me those.
所以我说，谢谢你给我打预防针。
Because I find Jesus is always very practical. You know, he just tells it like it is. He said, this is the way it is.
因为 我知道基督其实是非常实际，他总是就是开门见山，一针见血的说话，从来不掩饰什么。
But also, this relates a bit to your second question.
但是跟你说的第二点，第二个问题其实有一些关系的。
Because our function is to just tune in and listen to Jesus and say, well, what is it that you want me to do?
因为我们的任务实际上就是要就是找到圣灵在我们内心的位置，然后问他你需要我做什么，然后去跟随他。
And Jesus will use our skills, our abilities, our resources for the plan of awakening for everyone.
然后圣灵其实会用到我们所具备的在世间的这些知识和技能，然后用它来服务于整个救恩的这个大的计划。
And also with relationships, Jesus will use the ego attractions and the ego repulsions.
哪怕是在人际关系中，这个圣灵也会用到我们对人不同的人之间的有吸引的，就对我们有吸引的这些人，还有是我们比较反感的这些人。
So the curriculum involves meeting people that.Are just the perfect ones for us to forgive and to heal.
所以我们的这个行程，这个课程总是会，在我们在适当的时候遇到适当的人，然后有一个，宽恕的机会。
Let's take for example the two people that brought us the course, Helen Schuckman and William Thetford.
所以我们就可以举例，就看到就是把这个奇迹课程带到世间的当时的这两个人，海伦·舒曼还有这个比尔。
So they were working together to collaborate on a very important function.
所以他们当时是一起合作，然后去服务一个非常非常重要的一个计划。
That would have huge benefit for the whole human race.
他们俩的这个任务当时是会非常的造福整个的救恩计划。
But Jesus said that they had complementary ego dynamics.
但是当时基督就说他们两个人。在小我的这个人格方面是互补的。
I've never heard that before.
我以前从来没听过他是这样描述我们的人格的。
I studied psychology, studied Freud, but never heard complementary ego dynamics.
我也曾经研究过心理学，研究过弗洛伊德，但是我从来没有听过对小我人格这样描述，叫互补人格。
In other words, they were perfectly matched for healing.
也就是说，换一句话说，实际上就是他们的这个小我的这些人格特性是就是说非常互补，以至于他们是可以给互相提供非常大的一个宽恕机会。
Bill used more defense mechanisms of denial and repression.
然后比尔他当时的小我的保护机制的话就是逃避。
And Helen used the defense mechanism of projection.
然后当时海伦她的那个小我的保护机制就是投射。
And so Helen drew Bill out of his denial.
所以海伦当时就是跟比尔在一起，就逐渐带领他摆脱了他的那个总是尝试于逃避的这样的一个倾向。
Because she was so direct with him.
因为她总是一针见血，非常直接的点出问题。
But she was very unstable.
但是她并不是很稳定，她的心理状态不是很稳定。
And Bill helped her to relax and stabilize.
然后比尔呢也帮助海伦能够逐渐的，就是找到心理的平衡点，然后逐渐的稳定下来。
And they both were able to accomplish the assignment together.
然后他们两个人在一起能够非常完满地完成这个任务。
So that's how we make it through these difficult phases of undoing.
所以这也就是我们怎么样才能够度过这些非常艰难的阶段。
We are used in a greater collaboration.
圣灵会带领我们去跟很多的弟兄一起合作。
And we begin to focus our attention on this collaboration.
然后我们需要把我们的注意力集中在去跟其他弟兄的合作上面。
Because there is great fulfillment and joy that comes from doing what the spirit guides us to do.
因为在遵循圣灵的这个指引去做他给的任务的时候，是会带给我们极大的喜悦和满足感的。
And this happens a lot in our community.
在我们的新社区中，这个也是每天都会发生。
This idea of making a movie for the spirit has been circulating in our community for a couple years.
在我们的社区，灵性社区的成员里面，我们也是就是有这个灵感，就是要去做这个灵性电影，已经有最近的好几年了。
And we meet people who seem to be different aspects of the project.
然后我们在全世界也会遇到不同的人，他们好像是能够给这个项目提供不同的方面的帮助。
For example, I have a friend who lives in Hollywood.
比如说我有一个朋友，他是住在好莱坞的。
And she is a movie producer.
她是一个电影制片人。
And this year she contacted me and said, I want to make a Course in Miracles movie.
然后她说我今年想做一个奇迹课程的电影。
And have Helen Schuckman's story in the movie.
然后我会把海伦舒曼的这个故事搬到大屏幕上去。
Another man that we met is from Brazil.
然后我们还遇到了一个来自巴西的朋友。
And he helps finance movies.
他是愿意给这种灵性电影提供资金。
He has his business is capital investments.
他是做风险投资的。
And then we met a woman who was an Oscar-winning documentary maker.
然后我们还遇到了一个就是得过奥斯卡奖的一个纪录片的制片人。
And we met her when we were in South Africa.
然后我们是在南非的时候遇到她的。
And now she's living with her husband in England.
她现在生她的丈夫住在英国。
And so we keep meeting people that are all reflecting this idea.
所以我们在走到哪儿总是有遇到合适的朋友，他们总是向我们反射回来这个灵感。
And just staying open in prayer.
所以我们需要就是一起把这个问题就是坐在我们心灵中放在一个位置，就是不停地跟他祈祷。
And this is the way our whole community has developed over the years.
这也是我们这个灵性社区是逐步一步一步成长起来的。
Different ones show up and seem to play different parts.
然后有不同的人会出现在我们的生活中，然后是会扮演一个很重要的角色。
And then at some point it just becomes very obvious to us what Jesus is asking for.
然后到了一定的程度，我们就会突然的很明确，就是圣灵想要我们怎么做。
To give you one example is we have a building at our monastery that has a big log that runs right through the middle of it.
然后给你另外一个例子，就是我们在我们的修道院里面有一个房子，然后我们房子中间有一个很大的一个梁。
And the whole roof and the top half, the top floor of the building rest on this big log.
然后我们的是那个房，不管是房顶，还有就是第二层，整个全都是重力都是承载在这个梁子上面。
And we began to notice that this big log was deteriorating, it was rotting.
然后在有一天，我们就注意到这个梁实际上好像已经被腐蚀了，被侵蚀了。
But we said, It's in the middle of the building.
然后我们说
What do you do?
它是承重的，而且是在这个房子正中间，我们能做什么呢？
So we had a devotional retreat in Ireland.
然后所以我们当时在这个时候，正好是在爱尔兰做了一个这个修行会。
And this man came over to spend some time with us in Utah.
然后当时其中就有一个学员就跟着我们回到了犹他州。
And he, one day he visited that building, he saw the big log. And he said, that log needs to be replaced. And we all said, yeah. That's what we thought. But it's in the middle of the building. He said, I can fix that.
他说我能帮你们做到。
I can do that.
我能做到这一点。
We were like, What?
然后我们就说
He said, oh, I've done things like that before. No problem for me.
他说他是过去就专门做这一行的，这个对他来讲是小小菜一碟。
I need a team of men, and I need to rent some hydraulic jacks to lift the roof. He described it.
然后他就给我们就是说他具体需要什么样的人，他需要什么样的工具，能够把这个房子顶起来。
And so we said, okay, do it.
然后我们就说好吧，那你就放手干吧。
Amazing, it was a miracle. He replaced the log.
然后就像奇迹一样，他就一个人就把这个房梁给换了。
We weren't even trying to figure out how to do it because none of us believed that it could happen.
我们根本就没想过，就是到底具体需要怎么做，因为我们根本就觉得这个在完全在我们的能力范围之外。
But this is the way that our life goes.
但这个就是一个具体的描述，就是我们的生活到底是怎么运转的。
And it keeps our focus on the collaboration.
因为我们的注意力全都是放在去跟别人怎么合作。
So I think that's part of the reason why you were guided to come to this gathering.
所以我觉得这也可能也是为什么就是你受到指引要来到这里跟我们见面。
Because without a focus on a collaboration for the whole.
因为如果没有我们的注意力不放在怎么样去为了全体去进行一些合作的话。
The ego starts to focus on problems and make up new problems.
那么小我就会把注意力都放在这个世间的这些问题上，还有怎么去制造新的问题。
Because it's trying to scare the mind.
因为它的任务就是要让这个心灵感到恐惧。
我想问一个问题，就是昨天下午有一个道友呢问了一个问题，就是在您回答的时候呢，有回答到了一道，就是在关系中的真诚。
嗯、So my question relates to what we discussed yesterday afternoon. Someone asked about interpersonal relationship, and you talk about being transparent, being honest.
对这个真诚呢，就是昨天我就想问这个问题哈。现在我基本能做到亲密关系或者是平和的关系中能正确真诚地表达我的感情，然后但是我想问一下，如果在一段比较已经僵化了已经恶化的这个关系中，如果我想去挽回这段关系啊，就是工作中还有同事中这样子，然后如何能正确地表达我曾经压抑过的一些情感一些情绪，哎，是这样子。
So I notice like in my intimate relationship or a good relationship, peaceful relationship that I have right now, I can share my feelings in the honest way. But my question is around relationships that's already turned pretty bad. That, you know, in those relationships that if I want to save them, how do I express my feeling that I have, the feelings that I have suppressed in the past, and how do I express them now with the people? Because I have tried to honestly express how I felt, and it didn't go well.
Yes, this issue of trying to heal relationships comes back to guidance.
就是我们哪怕是想修复人际关系，最终也要回到圣灵的指引上来。
And it refers to letting Jesus direct the miracle.
所以我们应该让基督去指导奇迹的发生。
Because Jesus knows where miracles can be extended and where they can be received.
因为只有基督才知道在什么地方我们可以推行奇迹，还有在什么地方这个奇迹才能会被收到和接受。
And so Jesus would never have you extend a miracle unless someone is ready to receive it.
所以基督他不会指引你去一个地方或者跟一个人去推行奇迹。如果他知道这个人是不会接受你的话，他不会这样指引你。
And so this is very much a time of prayer, of connecting with Spirit, in order to be used in the most helpful way.
所以在这种情况下，我建议就是回到自己内在，然后去问圣灵，就是说到底什么样是最有帮助的一个方法。
It can be a temptation to decide the relationships that you would like to save.
这个是我们是有这种冲动，就是想自行决定哪些关系我们是想挽回的。
Because the Spirit has to inspire those relationships that are to be saved.
因为实际上，如果是有一些关系是需要挽回的话，圣灵需要启发我们去挽回这些关系，我们需要受到他的启发。
I went through this with my family, my biological family.
我是经历了这样的一个过程，跟我的那个就是家庭成员有过这样的经历。
I was so excited and enthusiastic from the miracles that I started to pick the people that I would give these miracles to.
因为我当时是非常兴奋，对于这个奇迹课程非常非常兴奋，所以。我当时在脑子里面就选择了不同的家庭成员，我希望他们能够向他们施行奇迹。
And I tried to do this with my mother.
然后我也是跟我母亲去这样做。
And she just listened to me, and then she said, "I don't need a minister."
然后我跟她一直挺滔滔不绝的在讲，兴奋的讲这些，然后她就跟我说，我不需要一个牧师。
I already have a minister.
我在我的教堂里面已经有牧师了。
But I persisted to try to extend the miracle.
但是我当时就一直坚持，还是想非常的想把我脑子里面这些想法全都灌输给他。
And finally, she said, "You need to find other people to share these ideas with." And Jesus said, "That's me talking through your mother, talking to you."
当时基督就跟我说，我实在透过你母亲发言。
And indeed, I had to go to Course in Miracles groups and begin traveling.
然后确实是这样，也就是在那个之后，我发现我确实是需要走到奇迹课程的。朋友圈里面还要开始我的旅行。
And let Jesus direct me where to bestow the miracles.
然后让基督去告诉我到底在哪里去施行奇迹。
When we try to love someone and it doesn't go very well.
然后有的时候我们非常希望把我们心里面的爱推荐给某个人。
We need to come back inside our hearts and ask Jesus, is this someone?That you would extend a miracle to.
然后，如果要是我们想这样做，但是对方也不接受的话，我们需要回到自己内心里面去问一下基督，这个是你的意愿吗？是你的意愿让我去跟这个人做这样连接吗？
And it's the same when we practice our no people pleasing and no private thoughts.
就是我们在练习没有思念，还有不取悦他人是一个道理。
We have to.Be guided to the ones that have the presence that can handle the sharing of those thoughts.
当我们在分享思念的时候，我们需要去被圣灵指引，去跟某些特定的人去分享，然后这些人能够给我们提供一个安全的环境，他能够支持我们把心敞开去分享我们的念头。
The first time we came to China. They listened to us talk about no people pleasing and no private thoughts.
我们第一次来中国的时候，有很多学员听我们讲过这个，没有思念和不取悦他人这个理念。
And they tried to do this practice on the QQ groups.
然后我听说大家后来就试图在那个 QQ 群里面去做分享思念。
And I think it turned into like a forest fire.
然后我听说的就像森林大火一样，也一发不可收拾。
Because the part that was missing was you must let Jesus guide the practice.
因为当时就是缺失的一点就是，你一定在分享的时候需要让圣灵去指引你到底去跟谁分享。
And so when we say no private thoughts and no people pleasing, it doesn't mean say all your thoughts to everyone.
所以当我们说分享思念和不取悦他人的时候，我们并不是说你要去跟你见到所有的人把你所有的想法全都说出来。
Because if you do this approach, you will get mixed results.
因为你如果这样做的话，你会发现你所收到的回馈实际上是不和谐的、混杂的。
So really, it always comes back to humble willingness to receive guidance.
所以最终我们是还是要回到我们要谦卑的有一个愿心去接受圣灵的指引。
And it sounds like that's what you're doing with your partner and close friends.
我能感觉到这个是你就是跟你的亲密关系还有一些平和的关系中的人是这样做的。
You can intuitively feel the helpfulness.
你能够在内心里面凭直觉感受到跟他们交流是多么有帮助。
And it goes very well.
然后他这个结果也是很好的。
And then with others, you know, that's the time to just pray and say, am I to say or do anything?
对于其他的那些关系的话，那确实需要回到心里面再去祈祷，就是你需要指引我去跟谁说什么话。
And for me, there were times when I could smile or give a hug, but Jesus would say no words.
所以对在我来讲，有很多关系中，当时我是可以跟他们微笑，我可以给他们一个拥抱，但是圣灵在我脑子中不需要说任何东西。
Yeah. Thank you.
I have 几个问题哈。第一个问题就是。一个人的意愿在祈祷、交托以及这个救赎计划里头，它的作用到底是什么？
你是说个人的意愿是吗？
对，个人的意愿。那第二个，
让我先翻译一下。I want to ask the role of our personal will. What is its function in the plan of salvation and in the process of surrendering?
Well, you might say that what seems to be our personal will is a sense of determination and willingness.
我们的个人意愿实际上就是一种决心，还有一种就是我们自己的愿望。
And our little willingness is very important in the plan of awakening.
然后在我们整个救恩的计划中，我们自己小小的这个愿心实际上是非常重要的。
We offer our little willingness to the Holy Spirit.
我们可以把我们这个小小的愿心交托给圣灵。
And it combines with the power of the Holy Spirit.
然后它就会跟圣灵强大的力量相结合。
And this is discussed.In different parts of A Course in Miracles.
然后这一点在奇迹课程中很多地方都提到过。
Jesus is always talking about offering a little willingness to the Holy Spirit.
然后耶稣经常在书里面提到，你要把你的这个小小的愿心交给圣灵。
Now there is something else. That's another factor that's also involved.
然后同时还有其他另外一个因素也是在这个中间起作用的。
And this is, you could call it, how ready are we? How ready are we for the miracle?
然后这个我就把它叫做，就是说我们到底准备好的程度有多少。
And this has to do with more than we can recognize in this lifetime or time and space.
就是我们到底准备好的程度到底有多少，实际上是这个是要超过了我们能够在这一生这一世能看到的这些因素。
For example, when Jesus came to the earth 2,000 years ago,
比如说两千年前，当耶稣来到我们的世上的时候
，His mind was very ready to wake up.
他的心灵实际上是的这个准备好的程度，要觉醒的这个准备好的程度是非常非常高的已经。
And he still had to be willing.
他当时确实还是需要有这个小小的愿心。
He still had to apply his personal will to open up to the Spirit.
他还是需要把自己的这个愿心交给圣灵。
But he was so ready to wake up.
但是他实际上是准备的非常好了，已经。
That it seemed to happen in about 33 years.
所以在他来讲，他的短短的33年的生命中，他就可以觉醒。
And so everyone who practices the course must bring this. this sense of a personal will of, to give it to the Holy Spirit.
所以每一个奇迹的学员如果想最终达到这个觉醒的话一定要把自己的想法愿心交给圣灵 去指引他。
It's like a crack of opening.
这个就像是一个就是一个
And eventually it takes us to our true will.
最终的话这个就能够把我们带到我们真正的上主的这个圣愿当中去。
As the Spirit.
然后这个就是跟圣灵的愿望是一体的。
Yeah.
好那我第二个问题就是在纠结和矛盾当中就是那个时候的祈祷还有教托的方向还有重点是什么样的
The second question is, when I'm in the middle of a confused state, in some kind of conflict, what should be my focus when I pray? And when I surrender, when I try to surrender, what should be my focus?
Well, I think Jesus addresses this in...the back of the text in the rules for decision.
当时在那个就是正文的第三十章的时候，基督耶稣曾经对这个有过一个答案。
He's telling us that it's easier to have a happy day if we start the day well and we stay clear.
他说，如果我们就是每天开始这一天。开头很好的话那么我们在这一天就会比较容易有这样的一个平和的心境
But when we become confused then it starts to get difficult
但是一旦我们陷入到这个矛盾和混乱的这个心境当中的话再想回来的话实际上是有点困难
Because it's harder to get back to the clarity
因为这个总是比从一开始就设置好一个比较好的心态要更难一些
But he gives us steps
但是尽管如此他还是给了我们一些具体的步骤
where we have to become humble and realize that we have made a decision by ourselves with the ego
在这个步骤他实际上就是说你首先 要变得非常的谦卑要意识到每当你处在混乱的状态中你实际上是自己做了一个决定
and that's how we got into the confusion
这就是为什么你会处在混乱的原因是什么
And so we need again a crack of opening.
So, 这个时候我们还是需要把我们的心打开
In which we start to realize that that we hope we have been wrong.
所以在那个时候我们需要有这样的一个愿心，就是我希望自己是错的
And we are willing to open up and come back.
我们很愿意回到正确的这个选择当中去
Because when we decide with the ego we close down we block the light
因为每当我们跟小我一起做决定的时候我们就把光明排斥在意识之外了
And in this dark state of mind we aren't really capable of praying truly
所以在当我们的心灵处在一个黑暗状态时候实际上我们是没有能力真正的祈祷的
Temporarily pride has taken over
因为在那个时候我们的骄傲实际上是变成了我们的主导
And then we have to realize that we don't like how we feel
所以我们当我们意识到我们自己处在那个状态的时候就要提醒自己我开始注意到我自己感受并不好
and we need help
然后我们需要帮助
and that starts to turn us back to the light
然后这个就是这样想就能够开始帮助我们慢慢的转变然后向光明敞开
So it's easier to have a happy day when you stay in the flow with the spirit.
所以如果你要想这一天都非常的快乐的话，实际上最简单的方法就是从一开始就跟着圣灵的一起流动。
But when the confusion sets in, that's where it's much harder to get out.
但是当这个混乱这个状态已经是你的现在的状态的话，你再需要把它拔出来的话，就是需要花一点努力。
There is a parallel in this world.
然后在这个世界中也是有这样的同样的情况。
Sometimes people wait until they get sick and then they go to the doctor.
然后在我们现在的这个世界上，有很多人会一直等到他病了，他才会去看医生或者想解决问题。
Hoping that the doctor will heal them.
然后同时希望这个医生能够治好他们。
But we have a thing called preventative medicine.
但是我们也同时也有个预防性的治疗。
Where you maybe take medicine or you eat certain foods or you exercise.
那个就是说你在日常生活中要吃的健康啊，或者是去做一些锻炼啊，或者是补充一些营养。
In order to stay healthy,
这样的话你就要保持一个健康的状态。
And so you don't need to visit the doctor.
所以你根本就不需要等到你生病了的时候才去看医生。
You take more responsibility for your health.
你从一开始就对你的健康就是下一些功夫。
And we can do the same with our mind.
所以这个就是一个同样的一个比喻，我们对我们的心灵也要是采取这样的一个态度。
We can become so well practiced that forgiveness.
我们可以就是一直去实践宽恕，一直去实践宽恕。
That we maintain our mental health.
这样的话，我们就可以一直保持一个非常健康的一个心灵状态。
And thereby avoid getting upset.
这样的话，我们根本就不需要达到一个就是很不好的一个心灵状态。
And so I think that's the way to practice A Course in Miracles.
所以我认为这个才是实践奇迹课程的一个真正的一个道路。
Practice it as much as you can with as much honesty.
我们应该就是在我们的能力范围内最大程度的去实践，然后给予我们最大的诚心去实践。
Instead of avoiding the course and just running to it when you have a problem.
而不是就是说大部分时间是把这个课程放在一边，然后只有到了紧急的时候才想起它，然后想去用它解救。
Yeah. Thank you.
那是不是说就是比如说我有灵感，然后呢我选择可能还是更相信那个灵感，但是那个人他可能就选择相信那圣灵给他的灵感，那也就是说我那个时候可能做错了一个选择，我选择了小我，是吧？那么我为什么会去选择那个小我？那个人为什么会去选择圣灵？这里边到底有什么发生了什么东西？就这里面。
So okay, this is another question. So what I'm trying to understand is that sometimes I will hear the guidance, but I will choose not to follow the guidance. And in that moment, I actually choose to decide with the ego. And for someone else, he might be in the same situation. He might hear the guidance, but he chooses to follow the guidance. And what is the difference between me and that person in that very situation? What is the reason that will cause us to make a different choice in that very moment?
It comes down to resistance or fear.
实际上这个最终就是回到这个话题，就是恐惧还有抗拒性。
Choosing to follow the Holy Spirit in that moment.
如果我们是选择听到了这个灵感，然后去跟随这个灵感去走的时候，
means that you are willing to accept the means that is given for healing.
然后当时如果你是选择接受的话，你同时也就意味着你是选择接受圣灵所给你提供的疗愈心灵的所有的手段。
But when you hear the guidance,
但是如果当你听到这个灵感和指引，
but are afraid to follow the guidance,
但是不敢去跟随他的指引走。
It is good that you are hearing the guidance.
至少你能听到他的指引还是非常好的。
Because that shows your willingness.
但因为这样就是实际上显示你是有愿心要听到圣灵的指引的。
But the ego is so afraid of where the guidance will lead.
但是小我非常害怕你如果跟随圣灵走了你最终会到达什么地方。
That the ego becomes afraid of the means.
所以他小我实际上是非常害怕最终的目标，但是他会跟你说他很害怕中间的这些过程。
Because the ego is terrified of the end.
因为小我最终是害怕这个结果的。
So in these cases, you have to be gentle with yourself.
所以在这种情况下，实际上你需要对自己非常的温柔，有耐心。
And say.The Holy Spirit is offering me a suggestion.
所以你可以对自己说，现在圣灵正在给我一些召唤，给我一些建议。
But I am too afraid right now to listen.
但现在来讲，我是非常恐惧，我没有这个胆量去跟随这个建议。
And so this opportunity will come back to me again.
所以我希望这个机会还能再回到我身边。
The Holy Spirit is extremely gentle.
然后圣灵实际上是非常温柔的。
The Holy Spirit will never force anything.
他永远不会强迫你做任何事情。
And the Holy Spirit makes no demands.
他也不会要求你做任何事情。
Just keeps offering suggestions.
他只不过就是一直在给你提供建议。
And knows that when you are ready, you will begin to follow.
他也知道每当你准备好了，你一定会跟随他。
There's one part in A Course in Miracles
在奇迹课程中有一个部分提到
where Jesus says there are many answers you have received
然后耶稣就说其实上你已经收到了很多的答案
but have not heard
但是还没有听到
they are waiting for you
他们还在等着你接收
so the guidance of the Holy Spirit is never lost
所以圣灵的这个指示是永远不会丢失的。
It just waits patiently to be welcomed.
他也只不过是在这块静静的等候你欢迎他的到来。
But there is no rush.
但是也没有什么需要急的。
And therefore there is no pressure.
这样的话也就没有压力。
还有一个问题就是，现在谁要是说爱，我就难受到浑身起鸡皮疙瘩。
My last question: If anyone mentions the word love, I feel very uncomfortable. I have goosebumps.
Oh, okay.
In a bad way.
In a bad way, goosebumps. Yeah. Okay.
你是
光
头
这
是什么问题？
这是问题吗？是个问题。
我
So this is the question.
Oh, that's the question. Well, yeah, love is a threat to the ego.
Because 爱实际上是对小我的一个威胁。
And is very welcomed by the spirit.
然后是圣灵是非常欢迎爱的。
But again, you just have to be very gentle, gentle with yourself.
对，就是又回到这个，就是你需要对自己非常温柔有耐心。
And just notice the feelings.
你只要注意到你的这个感受。
Yeah.
就可以了。
那个我们那个休息十分钟吧，因为
刚才
提一下休息十分钟。
Okay.
Ten minutes.
啊，
休息十分钟，我们上来休息间放松一下，回来啊。好，吃点门口吃点水果，然后这十分钟。
Okay, we're back.
好，欢迎我们回来。
Ready for the next question?
你也准备好问问题了，是吗？
好，好，回来，我先问。那个，我是想问一下，就是，那个啥，我听到就是多次提到什么圣灵啊、基督啊、耶稣啊，然后上主，还有可能我们说到的宇宙啊，或者真我，这些名称，他们都是指同一个人呢？还是这是怎么回事哈、啊？这个，另外的话，我们这里的好，您先。
Because I heard that you mentioned Holy Spirit, Jesus, God, true self. I just want to ask whether they're referring to the same person or what are they referring to?
Yes, it's the same presence, the presence of love.
它是一个同样的一个临在，是爱的临在。
And when we talk about Jesus or the Holy Spirit,
当我们提到耶稣或者圣灵的时候，
it's more like a symbol or a bridge to come back to know God.
它们实际上是我们能够通过的一个桥梁，去认识上帝的一个桥梁。
But the words are not so important.
但是这些词语实际上名称都不是很重要。
I always tell people use whatever words you feel comfortable with.
我通常是跟别人说，你就用你所就是认为舒服或者是可以接受的名称就可以了。
那他那个和咱们基督教里边或天主教里边的那个耶稣和基督是指同一个含义啊，同一个层次上在使用呢。
Are you using these words in the same way, as they're used in the Christian, and Catholic religion?
Well, I think you can only use words to the extent that they have meaning for you.
就是说，实际上我们要用这些名称的时候，实际上都是必须，就是他们对我们有意义，我们才会用它。
So sometimes Christians will refer to Jesus, you know, as the man who walked 2,000 years ago.
比如说在基督教里面，其实很多时候他们在提到耶稣的时候，他们指的是2000年那个曾经来到过这个世上的基督耶稣那个人。
And sometimes they will just use the name to refer to that same presence that's with them now.
但是有的时候他们在提到基督的时候，他们指的也是跟我们现在所指的一样，是一个爱的临在状态。
So the words just represent something to the mind, and then ultimately we want to go into an actual experience.
所以这些名称和词语只不过就是一个像在心灵里面的一个符号，帮你指向一个状态，但最终我们还是要关注的是实际的体验。
All words were invented by the ego.
所有的这些词汇和名称全都是小我营造出来的。
So we just have to let the spirit use the words until we can go back into the silence and the stillness.
所以我们就是要让上主或者是圣灵帮我们选择怎么用去运用这些名称，运用这些词汇，已经这样的话能够帮助我们的心灵最终达到这个静默的状态。
Because truth is beyond words.
因为真理实际上是在所有的词汇和语言之外的。
We can't really describe truth or explain the truth.
我们没法用语言去描述或者是去理解真理。
But we can experience it.
但是我们能够实际体会到它。
那就说，它并不是就像我们基督，就是那个宗教，想让我们去崇拜那个好像很就是很高大上的那样一个标志吧。他就说我们这个奇迹世界它不是就是让我们去把力量交给我们的宗教的那领袖啊，或者那象征性的人物，而是说这个力量它是在我们自己，然后这个上主它其实也是或者它就是这个源头或者就是我们自己，可不可以这么去理解？
So can I understand what you're saying is that in A Course in Miracles it's not trying to set up an external idol or goal for us to give our power over to, not like sometimes in the religion that we set up this image or this idol external to ourselves to give our power over to.
Yes, that's exactly it. That oftentimes philosophers and theologians want definitions.
就很多的时候我们这些哲学家呀，这些理论学家都是想要一个解释。
But I say, well, truth or God cannot be defined.
然后我就会说，实际上上主或者是真理是没办法用定义给它下一个定义的。
And so it's not within a realm of words.
所以他们是不可能在这个语言的这个层面去给它解释出来的。
But you are exactly right. We are not asked to give our power to any kind of form or any kind of symbol.
但是你是对的，因为我们不主张我们把我们的这个能力或者力量去交托给任何外在的这样的一个外在的一个东西。
One time I was going to get my car fixed.
有一次我去修我的车。
And I went to the repair shop and I sat down in a chair like this.
然后我就在那个修车的那个修理部里面等着，然后我坐在一个就像这样的一个椅子上。
And a woman sat down next to me.
然后当时在我旁边坐着一个女的。
And she turned and she smiled at me and she said, "Do you know the name of God?"
然后她当时就转向我，然后对我微笑着说，你知道上主的名字是什么吗？
And I just smiled back at her and I said, "Tell me."
然后我当时就对她微笑着回去以后，我就说，不如你告诉我吧。
Because I wanted to feel the love and the connection with her.
因为我的目标只是跟她感觉到链接。
Not to fall into a discussion of what the real name of God is.
我不是在这去跟他探讨或争论上主的名字到底是什么。
So I said, "Tell me."
我就说你告诉我上主，你告诉我吧。
And then whatever word she used, I went, "Ah."
然后不管他当时说的到底是什么，我都是啊，太好了。
And that's the attitude we want to have with everyone.
所以这个就是像我们在面对我们弟兄的时候所要持有的一个态度。
The whole point is to feel the love and the connection.
最重要的就是我们要能够在跟别人的链接中感受到爱和感受到这个链接。
Yeah. At this point, I'm not interested. I don't really care what people believe in.
所以现在在我这个阶段，我根本不介意别人相信的是什么。
They could sit down and they could say, "Hi, I believe in the devil."
他们可以坐在我面前跟我说，我是相信魔鬼的。
I say, "Hey, okay."
我也可以说，好的。
I'm just here to love.
因为我的任务就是推恩爱。
Yeah.
那我最后再问一个，就说，好像也有同学问过，但是我还是不太搞得清楚。就是怎么样，我有一再听到您说啊，听到基督的声音告诉我怎么样指引我，这我是怎么样去链接上，而且的话这个声音我怎么样才能听到我的基督对我怎么说，怎么去指引我，然后怎么去分辨这个是小我的声音呢，他还是我的上主或者我的圣灵在对我啊给出的指引，怎么去分辨。
This is the last question.
怎么去链
接。 You talk so many times about how the Holy Spirit speaks to you in your mind, so I really want to know how to establish this connection with the Holy Spirit inside myself, how to know that, you know, how to receive the message from the Holy Spirit, and how do I know whether it is from the ego or from the Holy Spirit?
Well, at the beginning, I desired that connection.
最初的话，我只是非常的有这个愿望，想要得到这个链接。
But at the beginning, I wasn't hearing a voice, or I didn't have any stream of thoughts.
但在开始的时候，我确实是听不到圣灵给我的指引，或者是也没有这个意识流会进入到我的脑海中。
So my prayer was show yourself to me.
所以我当时就一直在祈祷，就说请你显示，请你向我显示出你的本质。
So when I went through my day, I paid attention to what people were telling me and to the signs and symbols all around me.
当我有这个祷告的时候，我每天出去的话就会非常注意周围的人会对我说什么，然后他们周围会发生什么事情，然后路边的音乐会放出什么东西。
And then I started to see the signs.
然后逐渐的我就开始意识到，就是有很多的这个路标，有很多的这个符号都会向我指向圣灵的指引。
So it was like the spirit was saying, "Oh, you're still a little too afraid to hear my voice."
然后当时就好像是圣灵在跟我说，你对直接听到我的声音还是很恐惧的。
So I'll just plant little signs and symbols around you.
所以我就在你的周围设下各种各样的记号，让你能够找到我。
And I would go,
Ah.
I would recognize little pieces at a time.
我能够认出来他给我留下的这些路标。
Then I studied the Course in Miracles for about 8 hours a day.
然后我开始就是每天完全投入的学习奇异课程，每天8小时这样去阅读。
And sometimes my eyes would even get tired.
有的时候在读的时候，我的眼皮会变成非常沉重。
But after about 2.5 years, then I started to hear.
但是这样坚持了差不多2年半的时候，以后我就开始非常清晰的能够感觉到他的对我的发言。
So at first I could hear it speak to me.
一开始我是先听到他对我发言。
And then it said, "We're not finished."
然后他后来就开始跟我说，我们还没完成这个任务。
I'm going to speak through you.
我想通过你向外发言。
In public?
他说你们难道在开场合吗？
So that took more years.
所以这个花了很多年。
To relax.
才能让我真正的开始就是放松。
To say, take over my body.
然后可以达到那个状态，说那你就用我的身体去替你发言吧。
这个麦到右半球还挺不容易的。然后那个，当我想问的时候，其实我这个心慌，我觉察一下，其实好像是在蹦极之前的那个心慌，就是要跳崖那个心慌。
I feel like my heart is almost jumping out of my chest. It's equivalent to when I was going bungee jumping right before that.
我觉得可能就是那个全然的交托。想要全然交托前的那个恐惧是这个。
And I think it's probably the fear before I completely surrender.
我尝试着说一下我的这个与这个上帝连接那个感应的心理路程，希望能够得到大卫的指导。
I want to share my journey and want to have some guidance from you.
我是1999年信主的。就在这个过程当中，其实我学会了交托，那我也尝到了甜头。
I accept Jesus in my life in 1999, and from that point, I started to surrender my life to God.
以至于我知道，就是当我没有交托的时候，我会处在小我的时候，我就会不安宁。
And I can tell the difference when I choose not to surrender.I would be in a state that is that has concern and worries.
在我长达15年这个新心灵教学的过程当中，有近10年，就是我的工作是完全是被指引着工作了。
So I am a spiritual teacher for about 15 years, and 10 years out of these 15 years, my work are completely guided.
所以就是在2010年的时候，其实我是一个基督徒，我本身不相信轮回。
And I am a Christian. I didn't really believe in reincarnation.
可是在我是教排列和催眠的，在这个课程当中呢，就会降临轮回给我。
But because my work involves teaching people constellation and hypnosis.So during those experiences, I will receive message around reincarnation.
我知道，但刚开始不敢接受，觉得这是什么啊？这个与我的这个是相悖的。
And at the beginning, I had a lot of resistance. I didn't want to receive the message because it contradicted to what I believed.
可是也会觉得说，既然是那不是人教的嘛，人老师教的不是这样。那我就觉得，既然是老天给的，我就只有跪下来接受的份儿，因为基督徒经常祷告。
But as a Christian, because I pray so much, so I thought, you know, because this message is given by God, I have to kneel down and receive it and accept it.
所以在我的工作当中，就是我会直觉到，或者说这个事件的，就是所谓佛教说的什么他心通啊。这个素面通，那我的学生，比如说我几天教下来也可以这样，
可以哪样？
就是也可以知道你心里想的是什么，或者说你这个点，你这个事件过去发生了什么，然后呈现给你。
So after my class, a lot of the students can reach the state where they can read other people's mind or they have a lot of psychic abilities.
我知道。不是我的能力。
And I know it's not because of me.
Okay, 所以就是这个过程让我知道，就是你透过这个深深的忏悔和和解以及宽恕，就会穿越小我去跟上主连接。
But But this experience showed me just through confession and through deep forgiveness work, we can actually go through the ego and connect with God.
我呢就因为有了这个就和其他的心理学不太一样，我就从一个大的平台退出回到青岛，我是青岛人嘛，就自己有一个小的这个道场吧。
And then I moved back to my hometown and developed my own small group.
所以在我的工作过程当中，就会很容易的，就是巨大的创伤、自杀啊什么这些，很容易帮他疗愈，并且让他有一个，他可能就会去信主啊，信这个佛啊，就这样的过程。
And I had many many experiences where people came with extreme conditions, such as they are trying to commit suicide or different kind of extreme conditions, and it's easy for me to help them heal and direct them to believe in God or become a Buddhist.
所以我就会总结，我这里会总结说是用幻象疗愈幻象，穿越小我，走向那个这个合一之路。我是这样形容这个。
So the way that I describe how I describe my work is using illusion to heal illusion, and to heal the ego and go back to oneness.
从一二年我就有一个想法，我就想。这个东西既然不是从我脑袋里面出来的，也不是学来的，是老天降临的，那就不应该收钱。我老是有这个想法。
But ever since 2012, I started to have this feeling because all these skills and gifts that I give away are not developed by myself; they're given by God. So I shouldn't really charge any money for my work.
可是在心理学教学上，就是尤其是我们走得这么深的，你不收钱，那可能也不太合适。
But I don't really feel it's right to offer this for free because it is a very very deep work.
我就在想，要是去寺庙里，那我又不是和尚，我不知道怎么弄。所以我就其实有一个想法，就是似乎是流经下来的能量，那你就是应该是服务于大众的。我其实一直在找，所以我的问题就是，我似乎感觉就是好像这个方向，就老师说的这个状态，就全然的交托，是不是就是也是我的一份指引？所以我挺想听听大卫老师的这个。
我不太明白你的问题，
就什么意思？就是说，老师不是就是他们也是就好像一个社区，大家组织起来就是帮助咱们所有的人，就是心灵回归嘛，是不是这个指引？我其实一直在找这么个方向。
So because I feel like all this inspiration and all this energy comes from above and just come through me to try to reach all the brothers, I really feel it should be free. But over the years, I still am trying to find the true inspiration and guidance for me.And after listening to you and hearing about your spiritual community and how you can come together to surrender completely, I'm just wondering whether this is the same kind of guidance for me.
所以就是这个教学的模式以及这个收费，包括对于这个奇迹课程，就是我希望听听大卫老师给我的一个指引。
So in specifics, I want to hear your suggestion or guidance in terms of the form of my teaching, of my way of helping, and also in terms of how to charge money.
Yeah, I think this is a progressive lesson in trusting that all things are provided.
那你这个实际上就是一个要循序不断的这样的一个功课，就是要持续的去发掘自己对上主的这个信心，就是你所需要的一切将会被完全的提供。
And so the motive for teaching or for healing, need not be to earn money.
所以你就是说去教学或者去帮助大众的这个动机不需要是为了挣钱。
I do know a number of people that do their work, offer their work on a donation basis.
然后我也认识很多人，他们是做这个相似的工作，然后他们的工作都是建立在接受捐赠这个基础上的。
Recently, Francis and I were in Portugal.
然后最近的话，Francis 和我去过一次葡萄牙。
And our friend was working with a quantum machine.
然后当时我们在那块儿的一个朋友就，他的工作就是用一个叫量子仪器。
That you hook up something to the head and on the arms and on the legs.
然后他把那个仪器会跟这个病人的这个头部还有身体的各个肢体都链接起来。
And the machine will diagnose or report any problems.
然后它这个仪器能够自动的检测，并且发现这个人有什么问题。
And then the facilitator uses the machine to make the corrections.
然后这个仪器的操作人也可以通过这个仪器去进行一些疗愈。
And she, at the end, she said, "I'm doing this on a donation basket."
然后最后他就说，我做这一切都是靠捐赠的。然后他有一个捐赠的这样的一个篮子。
And she showed it to us and opened it up, and she said, "If you want to make a donation, you can."
然后他就把这个那个盒子打开，然后就说想要给我捐钱的可以捐。
So she wasn't charging a fee, but she was open to receiving.
所以他当时并没有在这个上面定一个价钱，但是他也是非常对于，就是说对于想要给他支持的，他是非常接受的。
And we meet many people who operate in this way.
然后我们也见过很多人都是在这种方式下运营的。
So there's no expectation, but also there is a willingness to receive.
所以同时你并不对别人有任何期待。但是呢，你也是非常坦然地接受别人的帮助。
I think that would work well for you.
我觉得这个可能对你来讲会是一个很好的一种方式。
老师还有个问题，就是我现在就是工作，当然工作的状态就是我完全的这个这样指引的。生活当中也是我能交通的三分之二。但我想就是我一提这个问题我就心慌，我就觉得是不是？很想全然的交托，但是有点害怕，就是那个好像临门一脚很紧张，不知道下面是什么。
I can say for my work, I have surrendered everything completely in terms of my work. But in my personal life, I can only say that two-thirds of the decisions in my personal life I have surrendered.And I do have the desire to let it all go, surrender it completely to the Holy Spirit. But there is so much fear. It's almost like stepping into the unknown can bring up so much fear.
Sorry.
你还有继续往下下去。
我想问一个挺私人的，老师看看能不能回答，就是你们这个就是心灵社区的这个关于利益的这个运作是怎么样？其实我也是觉得，就是安宁啊，人回归，我觉得这也是我的宗旨。我想借鉴一下老师这边
利益，
就是比如说这个利润啊，或者说
你跟这个刚才你的那个私人的那个就是是同一个问题是吗？
哦，我觉得想借鉴一下
啊。OK, so and also she was just saying that she wants to know how do we operate.In the spiritual community, in terms of profit, profit distribution, and earn money, and she wants to refer to see whether there's anything that can benefit her work.
Yeah, it has kind of evolved over the years.
对我们来讲，实际上是在每年都在逐步的，就是进一步发展。
When it was just me traveling around.From town to town using a car. It was very, very simple. Just very simple on donations.
最早的时候，就是我一个人只是开着我的那辆车在各个地方巡游的时候是非常简单的，我只不过就是接受捐赠。
And then when I began traveling around the world, sometimes the form would be people would donate frequent flyer miles or...tickets, things that would help me get to the gatherings, and that helped me go farther and farther out.
然后当我的那个巡游开始变得就是向国际发展的时候，当时就有很多人给我提供各种形式捐的，有些捐那种里程、飞机里程，以至于就是我可以有这个能力去飞到更远的地方去。
And then, as I was traveling around, I was very happy. Then people started to come up, and they would say, "I want to live with you."
然后当我就是我的心态状态变得越来越喜悦，后来就是有很多人找到我说想我想跟你一起住在一起。
But because of this thing called countries and passports and visas, it's not always easy for a group of people to all live together in the same place.
但是因为有这个国家呀、签证啊、护照的这些限制，所以对于想跟我住在一起的人来我这边住，其实不是很容易的一件事情。
So at some point, Jesus had us use the church symbol in the United States.
所以后来就到了一个时候，就是圣灵就让我们去用一个这个做一个教堂这样的一个符号，就是在美国设立一个教堂。
Where people could come in, like Francis came in with an Australian passport into the United States.
所以当我们有了成立这个教会的时候，就允许外国的人，比如像Francis，他拿的是澳大利亚的护照，他也可以到美国居住。
And she was able to get a visa through the church.
他可以通过这个教会办一个这个签证。
And she wasn't the only one, there were others.
然后他也不是唯一的一个人，我们有很多的人都是靠这种方式能够住在美国。
And then when we started to have centers in other parts of the world,
然后后来就开始更加的向进一步发展，就是我们开始在各国的其他地方开始有中心。
It became a little easier for people to come in and out of different centers.
所以就变得更加容易，就是说我们不需要都挤到美国来，然后大家就可以在就近的地方或者可以允许居住的地方开始去我们的中心。
And all of this was done just through prayer.
然后这些的发展实际上就是靠着我们的祈祷，然后一步一步演化出来的。
And we also have a principle of non-possession and non-ownership.
然后我们的还有一个原则，就是我们没有个人的财产，然后也没有个人名下的任何的东西。
So none of the houses are owned by persons.
所以我们哪怕在各个地区的这些中心，也都不是在个人名下的。
They're all non-profit.
他们都是非盈利组织。
And so we just follow the guidance of the Spirit as far as the movement of the people.
所以我们当就是决定什么人需要在什么中心常住的时候，也都是根据圣灵的指示来的。
And so we don't run into those issues of so much of possession and jealousy and control.
所以在我们中心里面基本上不太会遇到，就是说像我们需要拥有什么东西，或者是互相嫉妒啊，或者想要控制什么。
Because the ego will take this concept, this belief in possession, and it just uses it in a very strange ways that are not helpful.
因为小我非常的有诡计，他非常想要运用，就是我们想要拥有财产的这样的一个动机，然后把它加以运用到自己的这个目的上去。
So the community has seemed to grow, even though that was not a goal.
哪怕我们从一开始就没有过这个愿望，但是不可避免的，我们的奇迹社区就开始扩张。
And everyone who's come has come who very dedicated to the practice of the Course in Miracles.
然后每一个人来到我们社区的人，实际上都是全身心的奉献于修炼奇迹课程的原则。
Occasionally we have people who come who have never heard of the Course in Miracles, but they just feel the love and they want to be part of it.
非常偶尔的情况下，我们也有人来到社区，但他们不是奇迹课程学员，从来没有听过奇迹课程，他们只是受到这个指引和爱的召唤来到这里。
And they may stay for a while and feel it out, see if it resonates.
他们可能就是在这边待一段时间，然后感觉到这个是不是自己的道路。
But that's pretty much the way that it's gone. We are always in prayer, trusting that Jesus is leading the way.
然后这个就是我们是 就是这些年是怎么发展的，其实都是靠着祈祷，然后接受圣灵的指引，然后根据他的指引走。
还有最后一个问题，就是我想用心研读一下奇迹课程，老师有什么指导？
你没读过是吗？
没读过。
OK, I'm not a Course Miracle student, but I want to start reading a Course Miracle next year. Do you have any guidance for me?
Well, in the course it says there's no particular order or way of studying the course.
在奇迹课程它就是说实际上是这个课程没有一个固定的模式或者固定的顺序需要去怎么去研读。
For me, I was drawn first to the manual for teachers in the back of the book.
在一开始的时候，我最早是吸，就是被他那个教师指南所吸引。他那个是在这个书的最后面的。
So I would just use your guidance of just trusting your guidance and following what feels right for yourself.
所以你可以就是也是就是每次都问这个圣灵，你对他对你的指引是怎么样，然后去跟随他走。
And as I've said, we have developed so many tools and resources that are all designed to assist the practical application.
然后这么多年来，我们也就是也有很多的工具，有很多的资料去帮助大家进一步的加深对奇迹课程的实践。
We have worksheets, different kinds of diagrams, movie programs, online programs.
然后我们有一些就是流程啊，或者是一些自己的问答的表格，或者是像我们的那个在网上的那个灵性电影的那些目录。
But it takes time to get them all translated.
但是我们需要花很多时间才能把它们都翻译成其他的语言文字。
I just received an email today saying that someone had uploaded Mandarin subtitles to one of my YouTubes.
然后今天我收到这个讯息，就是有人帮我把我的那个YouTube 的那个视频加了中文的字幕。
And so little by little, people help out in their own ways to help sharing the ideas.
所以一点一点的，我们就是受到大家的帮忙，就是可以把我们这个信息传出去。Thank you.
我先问一个，我想问一个，是第一个问题是，我听这么多来，感受最深的是大卫是做什么事情都是要请教圣灵，是吧？那是不是确定在请教圣灵的时候，确定我是上主之子，还我是爱，还我是什么？你时刻处在这种状态吗？
So it's very impressive. It seems like every answer you give, you direct us to follow and ask the Holy Spirit and follow the Holy Spirit. So my question is, when you ask the Holy Spirit, do you have to be in a state of mind that you know you're the Holy Son of God, you're one with God? Do you have to be in that state of mind when you ask?
Well, in order to be in close connection and hear, it does take a life of devotion and purification.
就是说，如果你真的是非常想听到圣灵对你的指引，你而且跟他建立这样的一个关系的话，你确实需要把你的身心奉献给这条路上。
And in order to come into that devotion, it just takes a very strong trust.
那如果你要想达到这种奉献的状态的话，那你需要有很强的一种信任心。
I remember the first time I came to Francis's house.
我还记得第一次到 Francis 家里的时候。
And I was there with my friend Jason.
然后我当时跟我的朋友Jason 一起去的。
And I was resting from some travels, and Jason and Francis went out to get some groceries.
然后我当时就是只在他家里休息，然后 Jason 和 Francis 出去买一些东西。
And Francis said to Jason something like, "Okay, what's it going to take? What will it take for me to join in fully with you?"
然后当时 Francis 就问 Jason 这样的一个问题，就是说，好了，你就明确的告诉我吧，到底我需要做什么才能达到跟你们完全的链接
？And Jason said, "You will need to trust."
然后当时 Jason 就说，你需要完全的相信，完全信任。
Trust David and trust me.
然后他说你要 trust 大卫，你要相信大卫，要相信我。
So it started off very specific, and then it grows stronger and stronger.
所以在一开始的时候，他看上去只是要相信一个具体的弟兄，但是最终他就会一点一点扩散开来，然后变得越来越抽象。
And I think it's the same for friendships and for partnerships. You have to develop trust, and the more that you trust and things work out very well, then the trust grows stronger.
这就好像是我们就是跟朋友啊，或者是跟我们的关系伴侣也是这样的。一开始的话，你是需要就是逐渐的去发展这种信任，然后越来就是你跟他的关系越深，你的信任也就会越强。
And that brings up, somebody asked the question too, the question was coming, what is our relationship?
然后现在就是涉及到另外一个问题，因为刚才我听到我们有很多同学想知道我们之间的关系是什么。
And he gave the answer that we have a holy relationship.
然后当时我知道那个师光就给大家说我们是神圣关系。
And then they said, we want more. more details. so it's based on trust.
So we can say that our relationship is based on the basis of trust.
Based on open communication.
And also on the basis of very open communication.
On equality.
And on the basis of equality.
On sharing the same purpose.
然后是共同的目标。
And so what we share is we share for everyone in the universe.
所以我们互相之间，所共有的这些东西，我们是跟全世界分享的。
Both of us feel like this is a lifelong, assignment or a lifelong relationship.
我们两个人都有这种感觉，就是我们的关系是会持续一生的一个关系。
And at times our bodies seem to be together, and other times they seem to be off in different countries.
然后有的时候这两具身体看上去是在一起，在同一个地方，但是有很多时候这个身体是在全世界的不同的地方。
The first time.That we came to China, Francis had a specific translation assignment.
然后我们第一次来中国的时候，Francis 当时是帮我担任这个中文的翻译。
There was our friend Albert was translating my words.To the audience.
然后但是我们还有另外一个，就是我们的那个朋友永江，他是帮助把我的话传递成中文，翻译成中文。
And Francis would translate the audience words to me into English.
Francis 只是把大家的问题从中文翻译成英文给我。
Yeah. And so now it's reversed. She's doing both.
然后现在的话，他的那个任务是变了，他两双向翻译。
Yeah.And so, you might say that the relationship is meant to serve healing and enlightenment for everyone.
所以你可以说，就是说，我们的关系的目的是要，为疗愈服务，而且是为全世界的弟兄服务。
Yeah, that's the best way to describe it.
这个是最好的能够描述我们关系的一个方式。
It's not like a typical romantic relationship.
我们不是一个就是通常的这样的一个罗曼蒂克的这样的一个亲密关系。
But it's based on the function, what serves the best.
但是我们的关系是完全基于怎么样才能服务于大众。
And you could say it's very much of a collaboration.
然后你可以说我们的关系中是非常的是建立于合作基础上。
It involves You could say telepathy.
然后你可以说我们可以有通灵的这种感觉。
And prayer.
然后经常一起祈祷。
And just simplicity.
然后也非常简单。
So those are all aspects of it.
所以这个就是不同的描述这个关系的这个不同的方式。
那可以不
想
重点呢？
重点
又不会收钱，千万不会的收
钱。不会的收钱。好嘞，我最后一个问题其实也是想问到，就是怎么把这个亲密关系和亲子关系转变成神圣关系？因为亲子关系和伴侣关系是目前来说我最难宽恕的一个课题吧。
Okay, this is my last question, is how to transfer the intimate relationship into holy relationship. Because in my life, intimate relationship with a partner and with my children are the hardest for me to forgive and to transfer into holy relationship.
Yes, that is the purpose of the Course in Miracles, is to transfer from a special relationship into a holy relationship. And that's the purpose of the Course.
所以这个奇迹课程的目的实际上就是要帮我们把这种亲密关系或者是特殊关系转化成神圣关系。
And what we mean by specialness is the sense of expectations.
然后当我们说到这个特殊关系或者特殊性的话，我们所指的就是对弟兄的期待。
In the role of a mother or the role of a partner.
当你扮演一个母亲的角色或者是你扮演一个伴侣的角色的时候，就会对对方有期待。
There are unconscious expectations that go along with that, and cultural expectations.
当你扮演这些角色时，总有一些潜意识的期待，或者是甚至是你所在的这个地方那个文化对你的影响。
And when those expectations are not met, there's conflict or there's very intense emotions.
然后当这个期待没有被满足的时候，你就会感觉到有非常激烈的情绪上来。
And these can even include loyalty to parents.
然后甚至有可能会涉及到对父母的忠诚度啊
，or loyalty to country，
或者是对国家的忠心
，or even a sense of control and protection around the Course in Miracles。
甚至有的时候，我们有的学员会对奇迹课程产生这种保护感。
The first time we came to Beijing.Two Course in Miracles students got into a fight.
我们第一次来北京的时候，我们当时有两个奇迹学员在场，就打起来了。
And we tell that story around the world. People say, "No, you joke."
如果我们在中国以外讲这个故事的话，别人就会说不可能，不相信。
So there definitely were some expectations underneath there.
所以当时的情况下，肯定在他们的那个潜意识里面，对互相是有一些期待的。
And all of those expectations involve specialness.
然后这些期待就导致了这个关系的特殊性。
And so it is a transformation of going from what seems to be your human life.
所以这个确实是等于是一个转换，就是要把你的这个人间的这个关系，人间的这个生活
，to becoming more and more like Christ or like Buddha，
把它活得越来越像是基督或者是佛陀，他们该怎么活
？Sometimes people ask me, what about the saints？
然后有的时候有的人就问我，那些圣人们都是怎么样的呢？
And I said, we are all saints in training.
然后我就会回答说，我们实际上都是正在受培训的圣人。
All going through a purification process and healing.
然后我们现在都是在进行一个净化心灵的一个程式，一个过程。
So, over the years, I've done many teachings.
然后在过去的这么多年来，我讲了这么多次课。
I do have a teaching on YouTube called, I think, Parenting and Spirituality.
然后我在那个 YouTube 上也有一个视频，是这个标题就是这个父母亲子关系。
But I don't know if that has Mandarin subtitles at this point.
但我不知道那个有没有被翻译成中文，可能还没有现在。
But it's a very helpful talk in depth about parenting roles and children.
在那个当时的那个讲座就是非常深入的讲了这个话题，就是亲子关系这个话题是非常有帮助的。
And I think it's important to realize that it will take time to rinse the mind of these expectations.
但是我想强调的一点就是，实际上要想把这个心灵给清洗、冲刷干净，把这些期待都给抹去的话，是花时间的，是需要花时间的。
So Jesus and the Holy Spirit do guide people into relationships.
所以圣灵和基督是会指引人们去进入新的关系当中去的。
That are very helpful for healing.
然后这些关系总是会对他们的心灵疗愈是非常有帮助的。
So I would say that this is a pathway of letting the Holy Spirit use the relationships.
所以我说我们的这条道路实际上是一条道路，就是要让圣灵来运用我们的关系。
Unlike traditional monastic pathways, like for nuns and for monks.
所以这条道路是跟那种传统的然后修道院的这种道路像修女啊或者是和尚所过的生活是非常不一样的。
老师我有三个问题，就是第一个问题就是我就是有的时候总是被就是有什么就是疾病的词词语，然后就总是出现脑子里，然后我就感觉害怕，我就不想再出来，但是他总是出来。
疾病的词语。
对对对，就是我有一些恐惧的疾病的词语，它是出来之后又是害怕，但是我总是释放之后它还出来，所以想问老师该怎么办。
I have three questions, and my first one is, there are a lot of scary.Words that relate to certain disease or sickness that comes to my mind, and I'm very scared and I want to release, but seems like I don't know the way to actually let them go completely in my mind because they keep showing up in my mind.
Yeah, it's whatever has been learned in this world has to be unlearned.
就是我们在这个世界中学到的一切的东西，最终都是要被化解掉。
So, for example, a lot of people who are Catholic, who work with the Course in Miracles, find the Course to be very difficult.
所以我们有比如说有些学员他们是天主教徒，他们如果学奇迹课程的话，就会觉得奇迹课程非常难。
Because in their religion, they learn the meaning of words, and now they see the same words, but they seem to be pointing to a different meaning than the one that they already know.
因为在他们的这个宗教里面，这些词每一个词或名称都是有一个固定的意义的。然后他们在奇迹课程中会看到同样的词和名称，但是意义却是不同的。所以他们就需要去化解他们以前的这些理解。
And what you're describing is the same problem that people have when they are raised as doctors, trained as doctors and nurses, and then they get into spirituality.
所以你说的这个问题，实际上也有很多人，他们比如说他们的职业是医生或者是护士，然后他们进入灵性的修行以后，也会遇到问题。
All of their assumptions in their medical profession. Involve the disease being in the body.
然后他们的这个当时受的培训和他们的信念就是说，所有的这些疾病实际上都是身体上的问题。
And the body has a brain.
然后这个身体有一个大脑。
But in the medical model, there's not teaching around the mind.
但是在这个传统的医学模式，他们是不会教导你跟这个心灵上有任何问题的。
Unless you get into psychiatry or psychology.
但是当然是如果你进入在心理学的范畴或者是一些精神上的这个疾病的话，他们才会探讨这方面。
So it's best to just practice with the Course in Miracles and let the Spirit guide you in terms of these words that are difficult.
所以我对你的建议就是继续的持续的要练习奇迹课程，然后让圣灵去帮助你
逐渐的排解这些词汇在你这个浮现在你脑海中的程度。
I can give you an example from my life.
我可以给你我自己的一个例子。
There, when I was much younger, every time I would see blood come out of my body.
在我年轻的时候，每次当他看到我的身体，就是说，如果看到见到血的话。
I would get real lightheaded and feel like I was going to faint. So every time that they would draw blood, they had to use the smelling sauce so David doesn't faint. So then I started studying and practicing A Course in Miracles. And I knew I had this issue with blood. So a friend of mine who I played tennis with, he was into Yogananda, I was into A Course in Miracles. And we were both, at the time, we were both vegetarians. And so he saw an ad in the newspaper that we could earn money by having people draw blood from our arms as a study. And neither of us had very much money. So I thought, this is about healing the relationship with blood. So every day they would draw blood from my veins.
So
And the more days the study went, the more blood that they took. So after a while, I had holes up and down my arm. And on the last day of the study, the nurse came in to draw one more blood. And she couldn't find my vein. She was sticking, stick again. She finally had to get a doctor to come in and do it. So I sat in my bed and I prayed to Jesus and I said, okay, I see you're helping me forgive the blood issue. And I looked out my door and this woman was walking back and forth, but she was too afraid to come in to see me.
The nurse.
And so finally I said, come on in. And I said, come over here. And I gave her a big long hug. And I said, you didn't do anything wrong. This was all for me. And she relaxed. But this is the kind of experiences we need to go through to let go of these associations in the mind. So you just practice when people are using these words. Just keep practicing with it.
So 进入到我的意识里，就是能不能发生在我身上，我有点害怕。
Yes, because if I encounter people with the kind of disease, then there is a fear in my mind that if I keep thinking about it, then maybe it will come to me, it will become a reality in my body, and that will bring up a lot of fear.
Yeah, that's just the temptation of thought and of manifesting thoughts.
这个实际上就是一种这种冲动，就是我们的想法会，我们知道我们的想法会彰显在外面。
And you are describing what is the same for everyone, that there is a fear of thoughts.
你实际上所描述的是我们每一个人的恐惧，就是我们其实对我们自己的想法感到很害怕。
There is a fear about the power of thoughts.
我们对我们自己的这个想法的力量感觉到很害怕。
And this fear comes from the belief that thoughts can be misused.
然后这个我们之所以害怕，原因是因为我们相信我们有这个能力去滥用我们这个力量。
For destructive purposes.
然后这个我们会滥用，以至于它会毁坏一些东西，毁坏这个世界。
So your practice is with these diseases, but for others it comes in many different forms.
所以对你来讲，可能是具体的体现就是你害怕这些疾病的思维，但是对其他的人来讲，他们会体现在害怕其他的想法。
嗯，谢老师，还有两个问题，就是还有一个问题就是，我是一些。就是有一件事情，最近发生一件事情，但是，让我很难受，但是一直放不下，这件事情应该怎么办？如果要是有一件事非常在意的事情发生了，放不下该怎么办？
My second question, there has been certain circumstances in my life, and I cannot let it go. I don't really know what to do.So I guess this is just a question, if something really bad or negative happened to me that I cannot let it go, what should I do?
Well, it's a memory that is held to in the mind.
这个实际上就是你在你的心灵中去抓住不放这样的一个记忆。
And the good news is that all memories can be reinterpreted or purified.
然后这个好消息就是说，不管是什么样的记忆，实际上我们是都有能力能够重新，去理解它，而且去重新的理解它。
Because the ego is the belief system in being a victim.
因为小我实际上就是这样的一个信念体系，认为你是一个受害者。
So it doesn't matter whether it's a victim from other people or the government or society.
所以他不管你是，就是说他会让你觉得你有可能是这个对其他人来讲你是受害者，或者是政府的受害者，或者是其他不同的目标的受害者。
Or a victim of diseases.
或者是疾病的受害者。
Victim of genetics, of inheriting.Problems and issues from parents and relatives.
或者是基因受基因的这个所害的这样的一个受害者。
The ego belief system always is going to involve a victim.
只要是你相信小我的信念体系，它总是会涉及受害者这个概念。
And that is what the Holy Spirit will heal.
这个就是我们圣灵需要帮我们疗愈的一个东西。
The Holy Spirit will show that it is impossible to be a victim unless you choose to be a victim.
圣灵会帮我们看到，实际上我们不是任何情形的受害者。只有当我们选择做受害者的时候，我们才会跟他等同。
So first, forgiveness shows that the mind has been completely mistaken.
然后，如果你是进行宽恕的话，你就会有这样的体验。你会发现你对这个世界的理解是完全错误的。
And then a totally new perspective is shown.
然后对这件事情 的一个新的解释就会被给予给你。
It reminds me of with my father, when my father told me, David, I really was not a very good father.
我记得当时曾经我的父亲就在一次就跟我说，大卫，我确实不是一个好父亲。
And I said to him, No, that's not true.
然后我当时就跟他说，你说的不对。
You did the best that you could do.
因为你已经做到你能做到的最好。
I did the best that I could do.
我也做到了我能做的最好。
And let's not hold each other to the past anymore.
我们不要把对方再拴在过去的记忆当中。
And we both got very happy.
然后我们两个人实际上都变得非常的快乐。
And he was happy the rest of his life before he died.
他从那个时候到一直到他死都是过得非常快乐的生活。
So it works, but it just means we have to keep practicing with these memories.
所以这个是非常有效的一个方式，但是你必须要不断的实践，对你的这些记忆要进行不断的实践和宽恕。
谢老师，还有最后一个问题，就是你今天中午跟我说，在上古天国是有光，是光明的，然后。这光明是颜色的光明，还是感觉的光明，还是什么样的光明？
My last question relates to what you told me today before lunch. You said that in heaven there's only light. So what kind of light are you referring to? Is that in terms of color, the light is there? How do you define that, or is that actually perceptual?Light.
No, when I was talking about heaven, I wasn't talking about any kind of perception of this world.
那当我在跟你谈到天国的时候，我没有在跟你讲，在就是说这个世界上能够体验到的任何的表象情况。
It's really very rare, but three different times I was able to pierce through the veil of perception.
这个不是一个非常常见的一个经历，但是我有过三次这样的经历，就是能够直接冲破这个世界的这层薄纱，直接体验到天国。
And I would say this light is a light of wisdom.
然后我可以跟你解释，就是说这个光是智慧的光。
And deep peace.
是非常的深层的宁静的光。
And a feeling of knowing everything.
而且这在这个光当中你就明白你实际上是对一切东西都是没有无所不知的。
And complete oneness.
然后是一体性。
But it has nothing to do with colors or light as we perceive it in the world.
但不是我们在这个世界上能想象的跟颜色有关或者是跟任何的影像有关的光。
And so when we practice with the Course in Miracles, we're preparing our mind to experience that light.
所以当我们修行奇迹课程，实际上我们就在为这个心灵做准备，就是准备好能够接受这个光的体验。
If you saw that light before you were ready to see the light, it would seem very frightening.
如果你的心灵还没有准备好，你就接触到这个光的话，实际上它会吓到你的。
And so that's why we practice forgiveness, is to prepare our mind for that light.
所以我们在一起练习宽恕，实际上就是为了让我们心灵做好一个准备。
Thank you.
我想问一个问题。首先，那个非常感恩上主的安排。能够让大卫老师来中国用我们这个七弟兄相会。
First of all, I want to share my gratitude that God arranged you to come to China so that we can meet you here.
这两天来，我一直处在那个敞开、非常喜悦的状态当中。
And in these 2 days, I've been in this state of heart opening and extreme joy.
本来也没有什么问题，就是刚才在你回答他的问题的时候，我突然来了一个问题。
I didn't really have any question until the moment when you were answering another person's question.
就是刚才你提到你曾经是个素食者。
That was when you mentioned that you used to be a vegetarian.
我想问一下，这个素食者与肉食者在灵修上有什么区别？
I do want to ask, what is the difference in terms of spiritual practice between vegetarian and people who eat meat.
因为在那个特别是大陆这个佛教这一块，对这个吃素有特别的要求。
Because in China, especially in the Buddhist circle, there is a very strict rule around being a vegetarian.
所以说，我想问一下，在回归上这一块，这个素食者与肉食者的距离。
So I do want to ask, in order to go back to God, whether there is any difference between the vegetarian and those people who eat meat.
Well, all concepts of this world were made by the ego.
在这个世间里面，所有的概念实际上都是小我营造出来的。
And the purpose behind a vegetarian diet is one of non-violence.
所以就是说，素食主义者背后的很多时候，他们的目的，吃素的目的，实际上是不愿意介入到这种屠杀当中，这个行径当中。
And of not inflicting pain.
或者是不会给别人造成，不会给动物造成痛苦。
Or not inflicting death.
而且不会造成死亡。
And I would say the deeper you go into the mind.
然后我要说的是你。在心灵中间走得越深
，You do discover that the ego is the pain.
你会发现，实际上小我就是这个痛苦。
And the ego is the death.
小我就是这个死亡。
And so the pathway of spirituality is to forgive the ego.
所以我们在灵性的这个道路，实际上是要宽恕小我的这样一个道路。
And to be completely free of the ego.
而且从小我中完全摆脱出来的这样的一道路。
Because the ego generates attack thoughts and judgments.
因为小我会产生出很多的这种攻击性的念头。
And these judgments block the light of love.
这些念头和这些评判会阻挡我们对光的体验。
So in terms of form.
然后在形式上来说呢？
Deciding between a vegetarian or non-vegetarian diet.
So, 在决定到底是吃素还是吃肉的这个问题上
is very much like deciding between a purple shirt and an orange shirt.
就像其实跟你在选择到底是穿紫色的衣服还是黄色的衣服是没什么差别。
When you go deeply into the mind, you see it goes way beyond the form.
然后因为当你深入到心灵的层次当中，你会发现这个选择实际上跟这个在表象上的选择是没有关系的。
To a complete undoing of death and pain.
如果你是想完全的根除这个对痛苦还有对死亡的信仰的话，这个选择全不是在表面上的。
And this is done through guidance.
这个只有是通过圣人的指引才能完成。
And so, I would say it's important to watch your thoughts and to forgive the thoughts.
所以我要说的是，非常重要的一点就是我们需要注意我们脑子中的这些念头，然后去宽恕他们。
And as you do that, you become so identified with spirit.
如果你能持续不停地去做这一点的话，你就会跟圣灵非常强烈的链接起来。
In the East, it's called like the prana energy.
然后在东方的话，会有这样的一个词汇，说它是就是 prana 能量。
Yeah, where you start you transcend the whole idea of eating vegetables or eating animals.
然后到最终的话，你根本就是既不会去吃素，也不会去吃肉。
And the steps along the way, whatever the steps are just given through guidance.
不管你的那个就是在这个过程当中的决定是什么，是吃什么，实际上都是只不过是暂时的一步。这个是要靠圣灵来指引你的。
I have a friend.That I know named Jasmine, who does not eat.
然后我认识一个朋友，她的名字叫 Jasmine， 她实际上是根本不吃东西的。
She just lives on the breath. When I first traveled and traveled many places, I asked Jesus, what would you have me do in terms of food? Because I had been a vegetarian. And now I'm going to be going into many American and Canadian homes. And I knew that they were going to offer me food. All kinds of food. And so I had to ask Jesus, what do you want me to do? And Jesus said, here is your discipline. You will eat whatever is served in every house. You will eat all the food that you are offered. Because it is being offered in love. And you need to learn to receive. Well, this proved to be a lot of forgiveness. Especially when I went to South America. And they offered me bugs. I just looked. I looked at the eyeballs. I looked at the antennas. And I said, oh, thank you. And I said, oh, crunchy, very crunchy. But it was for my mind. It was for me to let go of judging food. Because it's the judgment in the mind that is the death. And it's the judgment in the mind that brings suffering. So he had me do this for many years. To wash my mind free of judgments. So now I wouldn't say I don't identify myself by what goes into a body. More recently, Francis and I have been guided to go to more of a liquid diet. And we shared this on the internet, and then people started giving us liquids. Soup and milkshakes. Smoothies. It's very nice.
I want to ask you a question about pain, physical pain. If there is consistent physical pain, what do you do about it?
Well, we are told in A Course in Miracles that there are magical solutions.
怪力乱神啊，对，在奇迹课程里面是这样讲的。奇迹课程里面的这个词语就是说怪力乱神的这样的方法。
So,
魔术的方法，对。
Yeah, if it's very, this could be anything from exercise to diet to medicine.
然后这些方法包括比如说要锻炼呀、啊、或者是就是药品啊，这些医疗的这些。
These are all temporary devices.
但这些都是暂时的一些疗法。
And it's okay if you have sustained severe pain to use anything that will help reduce the fear.
嗯，然后如果你身体有持续不停的这样的疼痛的症状的话，实际上你是可以就是寻求任何的帮助去减少你的心灵的恐惧，对这个方面的恐惧，任何的这个魔术的方法都可以。
And then as you continue on your spiritual pathway,
但当你持续的进行心灵的训练的时候，
you start to become more aware that all pain comes from thoughts.
你会逐渐地意识到所有的疼痛都是来自于你的想法。
But initially this can be very fearful.
但是一开始意识到这点可能会给你带来很大恐惧。
So you have to practice in gaining more confidence in the mind, in the miracle.
所以首先的话我们还是需要要持续不停地进行练习，以至于我们的心灵开始对这个产生很强大的信心。
So that you can release these attack thoughts.
然后你可以不断地化解这些攻击性念头。
And release the judgments.
然后化解这些判断评判。
Because everything that seems to be experienced in the body,
因为不管你在身体上看上去在经历什么，
is still a reflection of what's happening in the mind.
他们全都是在反射你心灵所中的经历。
So, for example, medicine can be helpful to reduce the fear.
比如说像有一些药品它可以是很有帮助的，可以帮助你减轻你对这个东西的恐惧。
And temporarily reduce the pain and the suffering.
也能暂时减缓你的痛苦和你的疼痛。
老师不能吃药，吃药会上瘾的。就是胃，如果不吃药的话，人他就会疼；吃了药，他就不疼，所以不能吃。
I feel like we shouldn't be taking medicine because it's addictive. Because for me, whenever I take medicine, the pain will dissolve. But when I stop taking the medicine, it will come back.
还有就是在胃这一块不用，就胸口这一块胸。
And pain is in this area, like
我想知道
around my stomach, around my tummy.
这是就是对我们哪一块的攻击
？And what kind of attack and which part that it actually attacks our mind? If the fear manifests in that area.
如果站在上主的角度的话，它会怎么样？
If viewing it from the perspective of God, what will He do?
Well, if there oftentimes is an experience of pain in the stomach or solar plexus, there can be a sense of anxiety or a sense of stress in the mind.
在这个区域里面，如果你感到疼痛，很多时候是在心灵里面会感觉到有压力，然后很紧张造成的。
And so, as you begin to pray, you start to go inside and go inside of the stress and anxiety and get a feel for what is it that I am fearful about.
所以当你在修行或者是祈祷的时候，你就会需要一直进入你的心灵去找到这个紧张的情绪和这个压力，然后看然后问自己，我到底是有对什么感觉到压力和这个负担。
Because pain is like an indicator that there is something that needs to be given attention in the mind.
因为疼痛实际上只不过是对我们的一个提醒，就是说它提醒我们在心灵中的一些地方，你需要有一些加以注意的地方。
And there are medical intuitives who are able to help and assist with going into the mind.
Medical intuitives?
Yeah, they're like practitioners that are very intuitive aboutthe thoughts and the beliefs.
然后有一些这个就是有一些这个
就是医务工作者，他们是非常这个直觉性非常强，他们是可以帮你看到你身体的某个部分有问题，那么他会指向你心灵是有什么问题。
Yeah. And so it's often called psychosomatic because it seems like it's in the body, but it always relates to the mind.
所以它看上去好像是体现在身体的某部分，但实际上全部都是源于你的心灵的。
In the Course in Miracles, Jesus says, all illness is mental illness.
在奇迹课程里面啊，那个基督就说，所有的疾病都是心理的疾病。
But that's not the way that it seems to be experienced by most human beings.
但是在我们这个在这个社会里面，大多数人不是这样经历的。
The pain can seem to be in the body.
然后疼痛看上去都是来自于身体的。
So.There are all kinds of techniques, breathing techniques, movement techniques, massage techniques that can trigger the awareness of these thoughts and memories.
所以也有很多很有帮助的在身体层面的这些练习，比如说像呼吸，某些程度的呼吸的练习，或者是按摩啊，或者是它都能够帮助你。接触到你心灵里面的某些想法。
So any of those can be helpful other than using medicine.
所以这些辅助的这些练习也有可能会对你有帮助，最终会找到这个源头在哪里。
终极的练习是什么？
What is the ultimate practice? It is the ultimate most helpful exercise.
Well, for me, the most helpful exercise was doing the workbook lessons of A Course in Miracles.
对于我来讲，最终级的练习就是实践奇迹课程的练习手册。
I just gave myself over to fully practice the lesson every day.
我就是把我自己的身心完全交给当天这一课。
And I could feel that was the practice that was given me by Jesus.
然后我当时就知道这个是。基督给我的这个礼物和给我的练习。
It takes a lot of dedication.
它确实需要我有很就是很坚持。
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, well, I think we've
okay.
We had a full day, so I think we've gone past our
time. 所以我们对我们现在今天。也是差不多到了今天结束的时候了。
One more? Or we?
你是要问题吗？
对。
OK, 最后一个问题好吗？
我是关于那个儿童教育问题，就是因为我感觉就是现在社会这种普遍的教育吧，它讲的都是不断的去强化这个物质世界的，其实远离了真实的这个。
My question is around education, because I think education in this world is actually encouraging children and everybody to be open up to materialistic beliefs and to stay away from the spiritual practice.
然后呢，他就用最宝贵的十年、二十年去学习的那些东西，可能他会用后半生去清理的，或者是像你说的效率呢。
So all the children in this world seem to spend the most precious decade, the first two decades, in learning about all these egoic beliefs, and then spend the rest of their life to undo all these beliefs.
So I want to ask, 就是说如何在儿童这个教育当中引进，或者说让他接触到这个，就像奇迹的教育。
So how do I bring A Course in Miracles or its teachings to children at earlier stage?
毕竟我们现在这社会没有这样的学校。
We don't have these kind of schools right now in this country.
那还有就是说我们在生活当中是如何引入奇迹？比如说我现在教育孩子五岁了，那么他只有在很高难的问题上，例如他问我这个圆圆姐姐怎么没有小鸡鸡呢，我说那就上帝这么设计的。
and also in daily life, for example, my child is 5 years old and only in certain areas they will ask me deep questions like why are, you know, women look different than men, and I the answer I would give is it's designed by God.
那有的时候会有一次我就简单跟他谈了一下轮回，然后有一天他就很突然的说，有一天我不喜欢我的身体了，我就 biu 自杀，然后我就再换个身体。
I remember there's one time I just mentioned the idea lightly about reincarnation, and she would come to me another time and say, well, one day if I don't like my life, then I'll kill myself, and then I'll just jump to another lifetime.
所以在我们我现在也听不到那个耶稣的指引的这种情况下，请你给点指引，就是我在生活当中如何跟他去谈一些相关的正确的
So how do I actually start bringing the truth or the beliefs introduced by the Course in Miracles to my child in daily life? Well, I'm still at this stage where I do not hear the guidance of the Holy Spirit. So what's your guidance for me at this stage?
Well, if you see your child as just as a mirror to your mind.
如果你把这个你的孩子看成是你心灵的一面镜子。
You would want to offer the most loving, gentle, guidance that you can offer.
你一定会希望就是给他非常充满爱的，而且是非常温柔的这样的指引。
That still is part of your belief system.
但是仍然是你自己的这样的一个信念系统。
So it would be very practical and from the heart.
So, 这样如果从这个角度来讲的话，你给他的指引会是非常有实践性的，而且都是从你的内心发自出来的。
I have had people bring their children to me.
我曾经有过经历，就是有一些学员会把他们的孩子带到我的面前。
And leave their children with me for a whole week.
然后把孩子放在跟我一起待一个星期里。
Or leave their children to talk to me.
或者是把他们孩子放下来跟我对话。
And I just speak from my heart.
然后在那种情况下，我通常就是从我的心里去跟他们探讨。
One time, a man brought his daughter to me who was about 6 years old.
所以有一次，就有一个人，他会把他六岁的一个女儿带到我面前。
And she was complaining about school.
然后他就跟我去抱怨他的学校。
All the homework, learning all these 7 different subjects.
然后抱怨他的功课，抱怨他的这些7个不同的学科。
And she said life was so much simpler last year because she was in kindergarten and there was no subjects to learn and no homework.
然后他就跟我说那个我的生活在去年的时候还是容易很多的，因为我是在幼儿园里面，也没有这些功课。
So I just spoke from my heart. I said I totally agree with you.
所以我就是发自内心的在跟他对话，我就说我完全同意你的说法。
All of these subjects are unnecessary.
我跟他说你学的这些课程实际上也没有什么重要性。
And she got happier and happier.
然后他就变得非常高兴。
And finally her father came into the room and said, what's going on? David, what are you saying to my daughter? And I said, I'm just speaking the truth from my heart. And we both looked at him like, Another time I was in Spain and a friend of mine studied A Course in Miracles and so did her mother studied the course. So the 13-year-old daughter decided to take off school for a whole week to spend it with me. And this little girl, she was a great artist. And she came to all my talks and listened to every word that I spoke. And finally she got a translator because she spoke Spanish and she's She said to me, I have to ask you something, David.
然后最后他就找了一个翻译，然后因为他是只说西班牙文，他找一个翻译去跟大卫说，我要问你一个问题。
I want you to tell my parents.
我想让你跟我的父母讲。
That I am ready to retire.
然后我已经做好退休的准备了。
I will retire now from school.
我现在要从我的学校生活中退休下来。
And she was 13.
然后她当时只有13岁。
And so I told her, well, your mother is a Course in Miracles student.
然后我当时就跟她说，你的母亲是学奇迹课程的。
And she will be able to hear this.
她可能是能接受你的这个想法。
But your father, he was an Olympic basketball player.
但是你的父亲，他当时是一个奥林匹克的篮球教练。
I said he will not be able to hear those words.
我说他是肯定听不进去你说的这一套的。
He's not ready.
他心里没有准备好。
And I said, would you just keep practicing your art?
我说你还是继续做你的那个艺术的那个绘画。
Because your art is so good that you can make a living just painting and drawing.
因为你的这个艺术细胞实在太强了，因为你实际上是可以靠绘画谋生的。
So I think you're on the right track.
所以我觉得你实际上是在正确的这个方向上的。
What is the point in developing all this learning and skills when you have to unlearn all that anyway?
你是对的，当你说就是在花这么长的时间去学一些这些小我的这个物质性的这些概念，然后还要花这么长的时间去把它们都化解掉，有什么用呢？
And I have friends that have pursued this path. They call it like homeschooling.
然后我有很多朋友，实际上他们都是在探讨就是一条新的路，就是他们会在家里面教育他们的子女。
Different cultures have different options.
在不同的社会和国家里面，似乎有不同的这个选择。
The very least you can do is talk to your children.
至少你能做到的是，你能够跟你的子女做一些心交心的交谈。
About what is truly helpful and valuable.
至少你可以跟他们探讨什么是真正有价值的东西，什么是真正重要的东西。
Because the children are just reflections of the mind.
因为最后这个你的孩子实际上是你心灵的反射。
And your mind is ready to go in a new direction.
因为你的心灵现在也开始打算要向一个新的方向发展。
And you will be offering gifts when you share this new direction with your children.
所以当你去不停地去跟他交流，去向他展开你的这个新的方向的时候，实际上你是给他一个礼物。
Okay. Well, thank you, everyone. It's been a beautiful day. So have a wonderful night, and tomorrow we'll come back for more of this.
希望你们有一个很好的夜晚，然后明天我们再继续聚在一起。